have some bad news about the game tonight. My keezer temperature gauge broke, so all my beer is 90 degrees. So
I'm taking sounds like first world problems to me.
I've got beer here. I've got a cup of ice, and then I got a thing of hot sauce just to make it interesting. So give me a second while I make my drink.
I do look at Omi and Bilbert. I'm like, you do know we have to find my barbarian friend, though.
I start unzipping my pants.
I don't think that's gonna help find
you. Oh, I'm sorry. I thought that was the barbarian you were looking for.
It does sound convenient.
Wish I had spent my money on something useful. Instead, I didn't.
How many saddlebags have you bought over the past 5 years?
Well, I bought 4 health potions, so I've got about 4 saddlebags worth of health potions.
Ooh. Uh-oh. Is that Nicole Kidman?
Oh, there we go. Hang on. Cancel. Yeah.
Is that what Nicole Kidman looks like to you?
It did from a distance.
I think we killed its family.
Yeah.
All right. Not so dire now, are you, Wolf?
Ooh! Ooh, snap, snap. Ooh, there we got were... Spate on. Hey, Spate.
Oh, hey, Spate.
Spate-ster!
Get this
man.
Fucker out of here.
Oh, he's fired.
Christ. Spate, I'm not in the mood to chug a beer. Don't you do it to me, buddy. Wink, 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 wink.
Coming in hot. To attack you.
A sick feeling in my stomach, and I cast Stinking Cloud and fart at the 4 to the left.
Oh! They're so scary. The Zentarum are real scary. Hello! We're back. We're here.
What?
We're gonna get started, but we gotta pimp our shit first. We have shirts now. Look at this. Look at this glory.
Look at my god, what are you sharing? Pimping.
Oh my look god. You guys want random encounter shirts. They are all kinds of colors. We got red. We got purple. We got dark blue. We got black. We even got ladies' cuts. Anything
you want. You don't have any colors.
Oh you can
Just a few colors.
Just check it out. It's down in the link below. Teespring.com/tunicofrandomencounters. Tunic-of-random-encounters. All right, let's get this shit started. We're already late. We got all the boys here. Look. Hello.
It didn't work.
Sorry for the delay, guys. Our stream key expired or something, and we had to reset that. So, but everything's in order now.
Dude, those shirts look sick, man.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Sorry, that was word vomit in the beginning. I just wanted to get this on the road.
It's all good.
Can't wait to get it out.
I got a Smokey the Bear tattoo.
I can't wait to wear it out and yep. Nobody know what it is.
Cool Smokey the Bear tattoo.
Just so you know, the stress of that last thing, I'm already 2 beers deep, so this could be go. Interesting. So, last time we left off, you guys did a whole bunch of shit. You took a shield.
That's all I need to hear.
Yeah, so what ended up happening was... God, I'm so... Gundren asked you guys to deliver a really nice shield to
Lady Elaine
Celestra.
What's her name? No, I remember her name. Celestra.
Alestra.
Wilbert said it first. You're inspired. All right.
Yeah.
So, Alestra. I need to put an indicator next time to show who's inspired.
What? What?
So,
we get inspired for remembering a name.
Yeah, you do.
It's just like in kindergarten, you get your gold star.
I just got my gold star, bitches.
Right. Okay. Oh, reset. So, last time, you guys met with Gundren. And he had told you he was working with Alestra, Nightstone.
You got it.
Of the Lion Shield Coster Company. She agreed to let you use her trade network on the condition that the goods were good. great. We're solid.
Good
so,
guess.
So he good asked enough. You guys to deliver things, because that's all Flip and Gundrum wants you guys to do is just deliver stuff for him. Tonight's mm-hmm. Stone. So you take the shield. Tonight's Stone, you encountered a woman who was being attacked by wolves. You saved her, and she repaid
Nicole
the favor
Kidman?
By... As do soon as you get in town, she stabs you. Stabs you in the... in the stabbed Covell in the side when her like minions came in and
bitch.
All that crap. The town was abandoned. It looked like rocks had fallen from the ceiling. A big gold dragon flew in. Copper dragon, not gold. Copper dragon flew in, laid waste to all of them, told you turned into a halfling, and he was like, hey pals, and you became friends with him. His name was Felgalos, and he was like, hey pals, good work, you should go see my pal up north, Javessa Shane. She's going to know what to do about this giant problem, because apparently he told you giants are wreaking havoc, and that's what caused this town to fall. So you guys were getting ready to head north to Bryn Shander.
What there you go. You got through it. You got through it.
We got the rest of it. We'll do the rest of it.
So you guys had just driven off the Zhentarim, or murdered them all, mostly. What do you guys want to do? And it's late in the evening. It's getting pretty cool.
Should we take
Gilbert was a good boy, also.
I was a good boy. I am a good boy.
Hey, guys. It's good to see you again.
Oops. Yeah, did you just show up? How did you get here?
Grayhair is back. All right. Well, not yet. Yeah, go ahead, guys. Grayhair's back, but not really yet.
Jesus Christ. JK! This is just a voicemail.
What's that? Who was that? Someone miming his voice?
Man, I had everything all nice and ready, and that delay just threw me off. Okay. So, you guys, are you going to bed down for the night, or what are you doing?
I'm attempting to pour beer out of the growler.
Okay.
We can... you want to throw a tiny hut up, guys?
Yep. Sure.
Okay. Pizza Hut. Is Greyfear here or not? I was confused.
Greyfear is not there, no.
Oh, okay. All right, we'll do a tiny hut.
Okay.
Where we are, just so we got some protection.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead and cast that spell so it tracks it. Well, it doesn't matter. Okay, you throw a little tiny hut down.
It'll regen. Yeah.
It'll regen. As you are kind of casting your incantation and setting the tiny hut up, you hear a crash. It sounds like through one of the ceilings in the building next to you.
Uh-oh. Okay.
Yep.
How loud?
Pretty loud. It sounded like something fell through the ceiling.
I know that.
I wonder what that could be.
Who wants to go? Anyone going to go check what that noise was? Go check it.
Can't be good. Hey, I'm gonna pick
you,
up.
Can you get in the tiny hut if you're outside and I cast it, or you got to be inside it? I don't remember how that works.
I think you're gonna be inside when you cast it.
All right, let's say that we were all in it. Tiny hut's in.
Yeah.
You leave.
All right, so I pick up my axe, throw it over my shoulder, and get ready to go kill whatever came dashing through the.
Okay. All right. Sounds good.
All right.
All right. You're in front of the door. What are you doing?
It's probably another freaking
You can hear some rustling. It sounds like there's some rubble in there. Like, something is pushing the rubble away.
I get my axe ready, and I hold it over my head in attack position.
Okay.
Say, halt!
Who the fuck is you're just yelling at the door to halt?
Oh, no, I open the door.
Okay, so you kick open the door, and you kind of see the rocks and the rubble kind of moving to the side, and a familiar face kind of emerges from the rubble, and it's Greyfear.
Oh,
he's following
the axe away. I know you're a little trigger happy.
For any new players, anytime one of our players is out, they always return by falling to the ceiling.
My ass kind of hurts. I'm glad I haven't had many days missing.
I did not. I reached my hand up and try to help him out of the rubble.
There you go. All right. Thanks, so you guys bed down for the night. You can all long rest if you haven't already.
But Greyfear can't get in the tiny hut.
We can cast a tiny hut after he gets in.
Yeah, you can cast it. Yeah, whatever. You can cast it.
I've been sleeping outside for a while.
I want a tiny hut to myself.
When I tell you can long rest, it means nothing's happened for the tiny hut.
Okay.
So, yeah. So, you guys go ahead and bed down for the night.
Give me that.
A long rest going through.
Can I search, for more poison plants?
Sure.
Cool.
And I will not chug this whole growler in classy IPA.
Middle town?
What?
We're still in the middle of town, right?
Oh, are we in town?
It's Nightstone. It's not a big town.
Okay.
Can I check the outskirts of
the town?
He
can search for poison plants in the sewer if he wants. It doesn't matter.
Can I search for poison plants in the sewer?
It's where half
well, there is no sewer here.
Okay. Well, then you're a fucking liar.
Sorry. I just meant
you said you can damn try.
That's right.
What's up, Evie?
Hey, Evie. She's peeking ahead. Evie. Don't worry, Evie. I don't think anything that happens in this campaign is going to be any way beneficial to know what happens in the future.
We'll travel to the same locations. That's about
it. Yeah. Yeah. Same location. The names will probably be different because we'll forget them and just make them up.
Nicole Kidman.
Yep.
And Tom right. Snooze.
What do you want me to roll? Investigation?
Roll a survival.
Oh, shit.
I'll take investigation. It doesn't matter. Either way, you do not find anything.
Cool.
Yep.
Nice.
So, shit.
We need to go to Bryn Shander.
Yes.
I think we take a boat. I think we boat to.
It's way up north.
Yeah, I know, but like, it still seems like the ocean would be almost a quicker way to go.
That is an option.
That's the option I vote.
But we'll have to hire a boat.
No, we don't.
We don't go to the ocean.
Well, it's a pirate's life for me, man.
I can bat down a hatch.
Do we have experienced sailors in the party?
No.
I'm one of a bear and don't sail very often.
I'm not really sure about sailing, but all right.
As you know, guys kind of get up in the morning and are discussing the best way to get to Bryn Shander, you see the ground, like, it just kind of, a big shadow just kind of fills and covers the whole town.
No.
And you kind of peer upwards to see what's blocking the sun, and you see an enormous tower floating on a billowy cloud 1,000 feet overhead.
Oh, shit.
Even from this distance, you can tell that the tower has to be hundreds of feet tall. And its spire looks strangely like a big, pointy wizard's hat. In fact, I'll show you what it looks like.
Harry,
I don't have.
I will show you what it is.
You're a wizard, friends, right? You're a wizard. You're a wizard, Harry.
Not even close to a wizard.
You are totally a wizard.
There you go.
He's a magician.
Can we see anything? We can't see anything.
It's black.
Cool black screen.
It's foreboding, you guys. That's a bad
thing. Yeah, I'm a little spooked right now.
Yeah. Should be.
The skies turn black. Are they having a full eclipse? Speaking of.
A familiar face.
Years of war. Okay, fight some locusts.
You know what? I don't.
What?
Where are you guys? Let's slap.
I'm gone.
You don't know what it looks like.
I'm at my desk right now.
You'll just use your mind's eye.
I imagine it looks like the food pyramid on the back of Healthy.
So it's a complete lie. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. All right.
Art
thing with the hot take.
So anyway,
art thing with another lukewarm take.
This huge spire that has the giant wizard's hat on top of it drifts closer. Mm-hmm. Some stairs made of clouds begin to form underneath it and start descending down towards you.
I know what these are.
The stairs actually look to be human-sized, and you could easily climb them. Although it would take
I don't know where these are.
Are we going to?
I
don't know. I'm just telling you a tower appears above you and some stairs.
I've never seen tower stairs before.
Boy wants to take the stairs.
I guess we could. I'm a good boy.
Oh, no.
Is there perhaps a cloud escalator?
Nope.
Guys, they said these castles don't come around that often, right? They're always moving. Should we take the chance to go up there, or do we need to find out more information?
Can we really call ourselves adventurers if we don't do it?
So, I thought we were delivery boys, not adventurers.
So you guys remember from the tales that that this tower kind of fits the description of what they said, that we're dropping the rocks on the town and killed everyone. And then came down and stole the Nightstone. Although there's only one of them rather than a group of three, like they described before.
Let's go up.
Harry, it sounds like it's time to light shit on fire.
Yeah, I mean, I'm always down. I should start walking up the steps.
Yep.
Okay. All right. So you guys are just going up to the steps? Up the steps. All right. So,
this is a sweet little trap
pal
you're
who wants
for
to
us,
travel
Pat.
With you is staying close behind you.
Here's our little pal again, Shield Lady.
All right.
Alestra.
So you guys step on these cloud stairs. They look really billowy, but when you put your foot on them, they're pretty solid. Like, really solid. Like, cobblestone solid. And you are able to just climb the spiral all the way up. It takes you a long time, especially those of you with some heavier armor. You're definitely feeling the strain by the time you get to the top. But you guys make it all the way up to the top, and you are standing on top of this cloud overlooking everything in front of this giant entrance to the tower.
Mm-hmm.
It feels, I mean, the cloud feels as firm and safe as solid ground.
Weird.
And you're standing in front of this entrance. It is
open. If we fall down the steps, does it hurt like stone, or does it feel like
stone? Only one way to find out.
That's an important question.
All right, guys.
I give Omi a light shove.
No, God damn it!
Wait. Does this mean that Vape Mom can make more stairs?
Ooh! Hot take.
Hey, Diet Skittles, how about you go play something else?
Eating more Skittles.
All right.
Let's go up. Hey, you know how long it's taken us to go up these stairs? Let's do it.
Good idea. I need con saves from all of you, by the way. All
right. Oh, Jesus. God.
Thank you for reminding me, Skittles. And those of you with medium or heavier armor, I need you do it at disadvantage.
Oh, shit. Did I click the wrong thing?
No, that's great. Constitution. Oh, check. It should be saving throw, but I don't think you're trained in it.
Where is that?
We're not looking so good here.
Oh, that's one of those things, huh?
Harry, you did a check,
it's,
too.
It's your check and your saving throw are the same for your classes. So, so the Omi, Bilbert, Harry, and Greyfear, you all take
thanks,
one
Skittles.
Level of exhaustion.
That's worthless.
Do I add that somewhere?
No, we just remember it. It means you have disadvantage on ability checks until you...
What's up, Diamond?
Hey, Diamond.
Thank you for being so... No need for lies around here. Welcome to the burn ward.
Dude, you just offended everybody on the real burn ward. I mean, we're ugly as sin. That was just rude.
I thought you were going to say the real world, the show. The real world burn world. World.
Is it a reality show in the burn ward? Oh my.
Alright, we're done. Alright, keep going, dude. Let's do this.
So you guys, you enter the first floor of the tower, and you see this big giant kind of emerge down the stairs. He is very eccentric looking. He's got giant windswept white hair, a wispy white beard, and a billowy purple robe adorned with gold stars.
How big is he? Is this Skeleton John's father?
I thought we took Skeleton John out.
this is his uncle's friend.
Is this Elder Rod?
How big is he? What's his size here?
He's real big. He is about 30 feet tall, 40 feet tall.
Mm-hmm. Could I roll a perception to see how awesome he is?
If you want, yeah, absolutely.
Check him out.
You can also do things like intuition to or insight to see if he is acting aggressively or anything like that.
Yeah,
perception. He is big, and you figure he could squash you pretty easily. Insight, Covell, see that he is a cloud giant, which matches the description of the people of the attackers from before, but he does not seem aggressive towards you in the least. In fact, he kind of seems happy to see you.
Cool. I'm gonna approach him.
Cool. Hey, Cat, on the stream, the place where the chat would normally be is not showing it. The Roll 20 chat.
What?
Oh, underneath right. You.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I didn't know.
You guys go ahead and talk, and I'll fix that.
All right, I'm going to say hello, Mr. Giant.
I'm going to talk really loud and really slow, like he's dumb and kidding.
I'm going to be dumb. Like, you guys would think somebody who can invent a cloud castle could also invent a cloud elevator. The steps were steep.
All right. Yeah. Says, hello, my young friend. How are you?
We are good.
You have to go, what is that?
Doing here.
Kind of a big, wide smile forms on his face. And he says, it's awful kind of you to carry this slow little barbarian man around with you. I don't know why he just suddenly got a southern accent, but.
Yeah, I know what he does in this
game.
Yep.
That's your go-to exit, Catelyn.
Well, it's good to see you, man.
Good to see you.
It's good to see you.
No, I
I remember last year's potluck dinner. That was a good time.
Why did you stop to pick us up? We noticed the staircase and figured we'd say hello.
We come in peace.
He puts his thumb out and kind of gives you a little patronizing wink, Kovac. He's like, well, my friends.
Can we just have him pat him on the head?
Says, my friends, I've been communing with some other planar beings recently, and he just kind of stares into space for a bit, mid-sentence. And I've got some information from them that you all might be able to reverse the ordning.
The ordning?
It's the ordning?
It's as I feared, guys. He's an idiot.
Covell, you better watch out. I've done some stupid things in my life.
What's the ordning?
He can't hear me whisper.
Friend?
I'm certain he has giant ears. He could probably hear everything.
The ordning. What do we have here?
Well, is that the new Stephen King movie?
No, the ordning. Well, it's the social order, which all of us giants adhere, and we assign ranks to each individual giant. But it's ever since the Storm King disappeared, it's just gone. And he spaces out for another second, just
Storm King
gone haywire.
Who's the Storm King?
Actually, Omi, you know the Storm Kings. King Hecaton. He was the guy. He was the kind of the Storm Giant who kind of oversaw all the giants and kept the order.
Storm.
Oh, Omi, not a giant, know about the Storm King.
Well, maybe we'll find out.
Oh shit!
Yes.
So. Okay. So how can we help a giant?
Well, I don't right now. They just told me to come find you and take you to Bryn Shander.
Well, so much for your boat idea, Harry. You idiot.
Yeah, I'm the idiot.
So would this occurrence with the Storm King have anything to do with stones falling out of the sky?
Oh. Yeah, I'm embarrassed to say my own folk, they've been wreaking havoc. I'm not sure what they're up to. I'm a bit of a... And he spaces out.
I think
a loner. A loner myself.
I understand. Don't worry, I understand you on that one.
I think I know what these clouds are made out of.
I'm just trying to return order. Everything's... crazy right now. What'd you say, Kovel?
He's been smoking the reefer.
He definitely has that look about him.
He's got that watermelon vape, man. He's been dapping.
You can't commune with other planar beings without a little effect on your own sanity and mental well-being.
Is he going to pass that shit around?
I understand.
All right.
Hackaton. The name's starting to ring familiar to me every time I repeat it in my mind. Yes!
Well, you guys want to go along with it then?
Well, hell yeah, dude.
Yes.
We have a flying castle or a leaky ass boat that Harry wanted to rent with the Never Sailing experience. So, yes. Flying castle, please.
Listen, I want to take this campaign in a totally new direction Catelyn had not written. You all
us starving to death on the water.
Fish.
I wanted to fight Cthulhu, and y'all are making me go to Iceland.
That would be plenty of chances to fight Cthulhu.
Now we're up here vaping in the clouds.
That's right. We could build a fan and have it float ocean. Somehow.
I'm your biggest fan, Peter.
Jesus.
God, this mushy shit.
Let's go. That was so sweet.
I said Alestra was with you guys, correct? She's with you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She's been following you.
You said our little friend, our little buddy.
Yeah.
Could be. Is it Sprinkles?
Yeah.
What was the name of that goblin that Harry and I peed on?
Droop.
We never did that.
That was a dark time for us.
five years ago. Yeah.
I've never felt so bad about pissing on a fake.
No, this is real. This is real, right?
It was real. You're
so,
right.
So you guys, you're going along with it?
Hell yeah, we are.
I've gone along with a lot of things. I'm in.
This is surprisingly not the weirdest. Let's do it.
My whole
life is going along with what a squirrel whispered in my ears years ago.
I'm still feeling weird about what Greyfear brought up about. They were the ones launching those rocks and shit, right?
Yes, yep. They were. It was.
Uh oh! Did you see Spatester cursed item to Covell?
Oh.
And by the way, when I crashed into the forest the other day, I'm so nice to this guy because I fell off this castle. I was trying to climb it.
You're gonna climb the castle?
I had tried to, but I fell.
Oh, okay.
A lot of vapes to be had, but
I know I got a little clouds in my eyes.
So we're gonna trust this dude that's launching rocks at town.
Yeah, we're gonna go with it. I mean,
well, he's not.
He's not gonna let us go away.
Okay,
he's gonna do the thing.
He's gonna keep doing shit. Yeah.
Did we get like some fancy castle quarters while we're on our trip? What fancy room? The hot tub.
We could. I mean, we could walk around. Maybe there's some cloud hotel up here. Reminds me of the Gulliver's Travels miniseries on ABC with Ted Danson.
So are we going to watch that? We're going to be the little guys who tie him down?
The Lilliput? Yeah, we could. What if we did that?
Lilliputians.
We like fucking take the whole story on a different path.
Cavell.
Yes.
The giant looks down at you and he's like,
here comes.
My slow friend. I found this item. I don't quite know what it does.
I don't want it.
Perhaps this ring will benefit you. And he hands you down a little
ring. I'm sorry. Please don't.
Oh, we did roll insight earlier at Skittles, and it said that this guy was A-okay in our book. But that was according to Covell, the slow barbarian who talks about he's an idiot.
he's been in the woods for 5 years. I got this.
He rolls a 20. It's actually a zero.
Are you able to tell me what I got, Cap?
It is a ring.
Oh, jeez.
Do I have to put it on?
It's a toe ring.
Is it a handsome ring?
It's from Spain. You have to put it on.
No. Let's take a look at it. How about that?
Yeah, I want to examine it.
Okay,
I'm going to help you because I don't think you're very smart.
I'm not very platinum.
I just investigated it poorly.
I'm looking at it.
Do you have the components for identify? I don't think you do.
What are the components?
Look at Greyfear there, yeah.
I think it's a pearl worth 100 gold.
Ask the giant if he has a pearl with 100 gold.
Can't say I do, my friend.
Okay. Put it on, see what happens.
You guys tried.
I take a look at it, and I feel like I understand a good portion of this ring.
I ask Covell if I can just look at the ring real quick.
Okay.
You can throw it.
But I'm just going to keep it to myself.
Throw it.
Covell,
I just show it to you like this, but I'm not going to let you hold it.
Swallow that eye patch. Remember that eye patch.
You don't have to do it. But,
can I attempt a dexterity check to put the ring on Covell's finger?
Yeah, well, I mean, you can not put it on, but just know I'm going to increasingly put worse cursed items until you get one.
I got to put it on.
Okay.
So sad. Right. So sad.
So you put on the ring, and you can feel
my first
the metal ring slide on your finger. And you feel like you get a little extra, like you're better at dodging things and have more willpower, and in effect you get +1 to all your saving throws.
And then
I don't know, it's fine. I mean, you just feel like pretty good, like it's making you strong.
And then
that's what happens.
My 23 perception of this ring show anything peculiar?
It is a simple metal ring.
Simple ring. I like that you were, Greyfear was about to say baby's first C ring. So.
will you add to my character sheet a little bit, Kat?
Yeah.
It gives it +1 on
I've got it up.
Okay. Cool.
Yep.
And then. Alright, so. Are we riding in the castle? I'm gonna go.
Let's do it.
I'm gonna ask the giant if he has a honeymoon suite. I can stay by myself.
Shotgun.
Well, I would rather you stay on the first floor.
Is there a reason you would rather us stay on the first floor? Insight check.
The second floor is my bedroom, and the first floor is the area where I control where we go. It's best not if you go up there.
Can I drive the castle?
Drive the castle.
No, it requires decades of training.
Can I drive the castle?
And my slow friend, I don't think you're up for it.
I'm going to do a suggestion on the giant to let me drive the castle.
Are you really?
I think he might get hostile towards me if I do that. Right?
He might get hostile towards all of us.
Yeah.
All right,
I thought this meant something to you, giant. I thought we had a special bond.
I'm just doing what the voices of the plains instructed me to do.
I thought you were my one and only.
I just want to restore the ordning, and right now you seem like my best option.
Really? Really? We're the best option? We've been told that a couple times, but it doesn't
seem like that. I think he meant to say last. He meant to say last.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
The language barrier is
older. Yeah. We were the only people down on the stairs.
He kind of starts going back up to the second floor, and he says, up the cloud stairs. He says, I'll be back. Let me set a course. We have a long way to go. It's going to take us about 25, 26 days to get there. So we're going to spend a lot of time together. When I come back, I want to hear some tales of you and your past. Pass the time.
Oh,
why not? Gosh. I love swapping stories.
This guy. He looks cute. I mean, he looks like he walks
upstairs, and you guys kind of feel the building lurch forward as it starts moving and going.
Oh, man,
I should really also know. Oh my goodness, what are you doing, Harry?
Harry, what's going on?
He's in the clouds, man.
Harry, what's going on?
Nothing. I wasn't doing anything.
There. Harry's
not
going anywhere.
I saw him.
I can still move.
He can still move.
Yep.
No way.
So he goes up and he sets a course and he comes back down. And he kind of plops down in his big throne up top. Big chair at his table. And he says, come tell me your story. And he puts his hand down on the ground. Oh. To offer to kind of lift you up.
I don't want to stand in the circle. The circle looks like a bad thing.
Circle,
that's the,
dotted
that's
circle.
That's where the stairs appear and disappear, where he's been coming up and down.
Oh.
What a magic boy.
Kind of reminds me of Game of Thrones.
Is anyone hopping on his hand that he's offering down to lift you up?
I am.
He's my buddy. I am.
Okay, so you both hop on his hand, and he lifts you up onto the table and kind of sits, resting his hand in his chin. He's like, "You!" And he points at Omi, the smallest of the group. And he says, "Tell me a story." And
about Hackathon?
You know of him? I would love to hear the tale. And you were reminded of a story from when you were a kid.
He went by a nickname back then. Hacky Sack.
So, guys, what we're going to do here is actually we're going to go back in time, a little dream sequence.
You do a Wayne's World?
And we're going to go to a moment in the past. Every time we do a flashback, I need you guys to do that. All right, so this is Omi's show now. So, Omi.
What the fuck? I thought that those boys stood in that guy's hands and did me? What the fuck? And he crushed him and killed him.
You are about 12, out fishing on the water by yourself. You snuck a little
splash,
snuck
a little taking a bath.
Off the Sword Coast in your youth.
That's right. Off water
deep. All of a sudden, underneath your boat, you felt a kind of wave start forming, and you see a huge shape kind of emerging from underneath the water.
Fuck Three Willy!
And it starts coming up towards the boat, and I need you to make a dex check. Even though this is a...
It's like a memory dex check?
Yeah.
Can it just... Not a saving throw, just a dex?
Yes, dex check. Or a dex save. Dex save.
You got it. Okay. Here we go.
All right.
Can we die in our stories?
No. Yeah, you just, it's kind of like Back to the Future. You just kind of disappear.
Any photo.
So the big shape is just moving too quick and you can't get out of it. And it just smashes up through your boat and sends your 12-year-old body flying, and you land on a rock just beneath the surface and fall unconscious.
So you land with your face up, and your face is just above the water. Yeah.
Ooh, thank you, whoever that's from. I didn't even...
There you go. Spate, god damn it!
Spate! Thank you, Spate.
We love it. But we're scared. That's the thing. But we're scared.
Spade's not going to do anything to me. He owes me for losing the base here.
Does that mean I have to chug Rust. It here?
Absolutely.
It I does. Think, I think you can chug your growler, right?
Yeah, I think. I'm not
chugging.
Volunteer
out of that growler. I'm not
chug the growler.
No, that's not.
Taylor's best.
Harry. Cheers.
I mean, you get beer. A chug beer.
Okay.
That's not what's happening. Right.
While he's doing that,
special beer juice given to me by a friend.
Omi, you awoke to two female giants.
Female giants, okay.
Staring at you, holding you in their hand.
Oh, jeez.
And they're like, "I'm so sorry, little friend. Are you alright? Are you alright?"
I don't know how to sail that well. I took Papa's boat out. I took Papa and Uncle's boat out.
The younger of the giants looks to the older one and says, "Oh, he's cute. I like him." So the giants introduce themselves. One is Queen Neri, and the other is Princess Ceressa. And upon this chance encounter, you spent the summer kind of teaching them about the ways of small folk, which is what they call you, and they taught you the ways of the giant, kind of some of the ideas behind their society, and also taught you how to speak giant, which is why you can speak giant.
I was at the right age at the right time, otherwise I wouldn't.
Mm-hmm. And you hung out with them for the rest of the summer.
A Porky's 5?
Yeah, fast forward. So as summer kind of started winding down, you guys have been meeting in secret, because obviously your parents would flip out knowing you were hanging out with two giants. and they aren't really supposed to engage with the small folk. But you guys are having a meeting, and you're kind of teaching them and showing them a new song that you've been working on, and when all of a sudden behind them, a male giant that is much larger than both of them kind of erupts out from the ocean. And he says, "What are you doing?" And they both kind of look back at him, and they're like, oh, "We're, we're." And Sarissa kind of hides you behind her back. And I know you've got a small one back there. She kind of holds you out and says,
"No!
I'm sorry. He's so cute." He's like, "Get back to the maelstrom."
I'm like a hamster.
And she kind of goes to you and says, "I'm sorry. I had a great time, but this is the last we'll see of one another." And she sets you down on the beach, and sheepishly, both of them walk into...
That was Omi's one true love.
Walk into the maelstrom.
That was my first love, my first girlfriend. Princess. Princess giant. Princess bride giant.
Yep.
Could we just call it Bridezilla? For sure.
Bridezilla! I was only 12, but I loved it. She gave me Pop-Tarts in bed.
Did she take your virginity?
All right,
no, she didn't. I'm still a V-boy.
I'll let you think. Do I check what's inside of this or what's inside of this box?
Go
ahead. Oh, yeah, he's got to choose. While Spade's choosing, the giant looks at you. He's like, "A mighty fine tale. I wish we would have got some time to spend with one another, but the storm giants are respectable. Who else has a fine story?
What's your name?"
And he gestures to all of you. Spate wants the growler.
Let me tell the giant about the night I got fucked up before I did work today.
Taylor Drew wants Taylor wants both, though. Taylor wants both, Chuck.
Well, yeah. She didn't drop 20.
Yeah!
Is Jake's video frozen?
No. I hope not.
I see him. No? He's great.
Okay.
All right. It's gonna suck.
He died that
solidarity.
Night.
Actually, I'll pop one of these up and do it in solidarity.
What are you drinking? I'm curious because this is beer that
I am drinking a pretty heavy stout. It's like 10%, I think. So
okay, then you're actually a little bit higher than me. This is double IPA.
Okay,
this is the Ready Steady Go by Short Story and Brewing Company.
Three, two, one, go.
Oh man,
yeah, there we go. Thank you,
Space. My heart's going out. Oh shit, you guys are nuts. Oh,
it's man. A lot harder to chug an RPA. I'm gonna be honest though.
Alright, so
Space Cat.
So yeah, which one of you wants to go next on your story? And these are just quick little background.
I will go next because this giant is not my betrothed because he gave me a ring.
Our special bear is gonna tell us a story. Our care bear.
Koval, you start regaling him with tales from the frozen north. One time when you were up in the frozen north hunting, you came to a clearing and you saw a white dragon with the corpse of a wizard sitting on a saddle on her back. You can hear the white dragon kind of weeping and talking aloud to her master's corpse. Something about she's sad that she lost the ring and she doesn't know where it is. Apparently it had fallen off somewhere. She's looking really sad and pathetic, like just kind of head in the snow, like weeping, clearly just overcome with grief. It's almost like she has not realized that the wizard that is on her back in the saddle has been, looks like, dead for months.
Ooh. Okay.
I'm sorry, I can't
see it. How old am I right now?
You are, how old are you in real life right now, in game current game time?
That's a good question. Late 20s.
Okay, so, yeah. This is when you were like 17.
Okay.
This is before you met the group. So you actually notice that the wizard, she's crying about the ring. Not only has the ring fallen off, but it's the wizard's entire hand has rotted and fallen off into the snow. You can see a little blood spatter where it is.
Oh God.
I cautiously and slowly approach the hand.
Okay.
And
it looks like she hasn't really noticed you.
Is there a ring on the hand?
Yes, there is.
So I just kind of I pick it up and I hold it up to her. I say, "Is this what you're looking for?"
She kind of leaps up and goes, "Oh my goodness!" and kind of just pounces down on you and wraps her tail around you and just kind of gives you a big hug. And she's like, "Oh, thank you! I owe you so much. He was gonna be so mad at me."
Can't breathe.
As she's holding you kind of tight, you notice something is just... the gleam in the corpse's eye or something just looks a little off from that corpse. Like, typically, corpse's eyes don't glisten. It kind of leaves you uneasy.
Yeah, I kind of try to wiggle out of her tail.
She says, "Oh, I'm sorry. I must be crushing you." And she sets you back down.
I create a little bit of distance. I point at the corpse on her back and say, "What is that thing?"
This is Maurice. He's my rider.
I think he was Maurice.
What do you mean?
Yeah. Looks like Maurice may have passed his expiration date a while ago.
She kind of tilts back and looks at the corpse of the wizard. And she says, "Maurice, is there something you're not telling me?"
And, Maurice Sendak.
It just sits there, kind of. And she's like, "I knew he was fooling." And she turns to you and says, "Go joke with someone else."
I'm just very uneasy, and I try to create a little more distance.
She says, "Oh, for your assistance." And she reaches back and she pulls out a big two-handed battle axe from like her satchel of goods that she's been collecting. And she's like, "Here, take this with you. In return for returning his ring. He was most displeased."
"Oh, I'm sure he was. Thank you. Can I ask where you got this?"
"Oh, well, you know, from barbarians who got in my way."
"Oh, I'll be sure not to get in your way."
"I'm Arvaturus, by the way. I hope we meet again."
"Yeah."
And I guess she kind of sets up to fly away. As she kind of bends down to push off the ground, you see one last strange glint in that corpse's eye, and she flies off into the distance.
I don't like that. Ta-da. I only have one bit.
And that is your tale. The giant is like, "Oh, mighty fine tale, and a creepy one at that. Is it true?" "It is true, Covell."
"It is true, yes. I can't remember what happened to that axe, though. I wish
you
I
have did. It. It's the axe you started with when you were adventuring."
"Oh, that was a shitty axe."
"Question is..."
"I feel like I got ripped off. I should have kept that ring for myself."
All right. He's like, "Very, very good, very good. Now, who wants to go next? Actually, it is time for bed. I will turn in. We will continue this tomorrow." And he retreats to his chambers.
Do we get a long rest for our exhaustion fall off?
Yes, you can rest right now. It's great.
It's great.
It's great.
It's all great.
Will our exhaustion fall off of the long rest?
Yes, yes, it's gone. Okay, you guys are more than welcome. You're just bedding down. You aren't doing anything crazy.
Is there a kitchen in this place?
No, there is not.
Holy shit, that beer went right to my head.
I'm gonna fall asleep on his chair.
Good place.
Okay, there. That sounds good. So you all are bedding down.
No need for a tiny hut? Do you think we're
pretty
safe?
You're more than welcome to. It seems very well fortified, and you're also 1,000 feet up in the air.
I don't trust it. I'm casting tiny hut.
You think? Yeah, go ahead. You can cast it. Whatever you want.
I'm sleeping on the chair. I'm
going to be like a little cat. Not sleeping with you guys. You smell.
I'm a cat. Mm-hmm. Let me sleep on the chair.
All right. So, You guys rest for the night, and then bright in the morning, he comes down, and
don't sit on me.
Zephyros emerges back from the ceiling.
He's back. Oh god, Dad's back.
And in his hand,
he's so big.
A giant. It looks like a goose that was cooked. It is more than enough.
Our goose is cooked, boys.
goose we owned. We owned that goose, and it's cooked.
It looks like a goose, but maybe it had some scales on it. You aren't really sure.
Oh god!
So not a goose.
You're more than welcome. You're more than welcome to try and.
Yeah, I eat it. I
do
eat
nature.
No, no, no! You should identify.
Oh my god! This giant goose-looking thing, which is more than enough for the five of you plus your companion.
I eat it.
Oh my god!
All right.
Harry, a beer did go to your head.
It is quite delicious.
I'm having more.
It's probably one of the best meals you've had in a while.
Delicious. It's fantastic. As I look at the guys.
There you go. Covell, I need you to roll a D10 for me real quick.
Covell just cross paths with that.
Just roll me a D10.
I'm afraid.
That's what I'm thinking.
What'd you roll?
Your hand just rotted off.
All right. So when you wake up, you just... Did you do the tiny hut, Pete?
Yeah, I did do a tiny hut.
So when you
just me, I think I was the only one in it.
Oh, okay. So everyone else in the room besides Pete, since you're in the hut, kind of smells this horrible, horrible.
Sorry,
stench,
guys.
And it is emanating from Covell.
Covell, what the fuck, dude?
Horrible.
Did you shit in your pants?
For the rest, until you take a long rest, you will have disadvantage on persuasion checks.
Well, I have
all of us
anyway.
Just him.
Somebody go get him some Old Spice right now. Come on.
He needs some new spice. He needs some. I don't know what the fuck this guy needs. Wait, how long is this? Every game, every time he wakes up,
this is his curse.
Yeah, we'll see.
We're chatting earlier. Do I still have that really great bag?
Yes, you do.
It no longer moans.
Yeah,
it no longer moans because you killed Skeleton John. It removed the moaning, but it still retained its magical.
Killing Skeleton John removes the moaning.
All right, so
I love that.
Remove the ring.
What happens if you remove the ring?
Yeah.
Are you going to pull it off?
I'm going to give it a little.
Be careful about it. Be careful. Okay.
You start pulling the ring off, and you think you feel your finger just detach. But luckily, it's just your ring was super tight, and it kind of went numb for a bit, and you pop the ring off. And then you still smell really bad. Like
the curse is in your life now.
You feel a little more sluggish, a little more less will, meaning you no longer get the saves. But you still stay.
I pop that baby back on because I'm a barbarian anyway.
Pop it back on. All right, cool.
Now you feel better.
So Zephyros scoots over and looks at you, Greyfear. He's like, excuse me. May I have my seat back?
If you pet me.
He says, that's strange, but fair request.
That's strange, but
pats you on the head. And he kind of picks you up by the back of your shirt and lifts you up on top of the table. And he falls back down.
I'd like to roll for arousal.
And go ahead and do advantage. And y'all, he's like, so who wishes to go today?
I'll go.
Your stories, even though we're doing them in like 5 minutes, it takes you about an hour, hour and a half to get through your story.
I'll go.
All right, Bilbert.
Oh, Pete, you just messaged me back. Isn't that
so? Yeah, it took a while. But...
Bilbert, you try and come up with a good story, and you remember, not too long ago, you actually tagged along with a Harper when you were just starting your business,
Bilbert's Privates?
Yeah, Bilbert's Private Investigation. just when you were getting that started, a Harper named Beldora asked you to come along on an adventure with you, with her. And
what is a harper?
A harper? You guys know what the harpers are.
Harpy?
I need to put it in this one. I will show it to you guys.
Please.
Those naked angel ladies? Is that the one?
Yeah, yeah,
show it
exactly.
To us like you shared that last bird one? Bitches?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I know harpers, show to players, show to everyone. All right, there's the harpers. That's their banner. They are spellcasters and spies who pretty much oppose the abuse of power, pretty much magical or otherwise. They work alone or in small cells, and they gather information throughout Faerun.
Oh, we talked about them, Pete.
They kind of act as political spies within each region and help the weak, the poor, and the
oppressed.
Act openly as a last resort. There you go. So that's what the harpers are. They're kind of like Robin Hood. Think of it that way. All right. So you tagged along with Beldora, and you guys traveled for about a week. When all of a sudden you're going through a kind of a more wet area, when all of a sudden the ground kind of let loose beneath you, and you both tumble down into this ramp, and slide down into a cave. And find yourself surrounded by about 30 gargoyles.
Oh, wow!
Cool.
and they all turn to both of you. And
good story.
Sure.
Good story.
Yes. Yeah, and they
biodome.
They immediately lurch for you to grab you. They don't seem like they're going to attack, but they're going to try and grab you. Beldora just kind of freezes and lets them take her. Bilbert, what are you doing?
The harp symbol isn't showing on the stream, by the way.
The what?
The harp banner isn't on the stream.
The harp banner?
He just showed it to us. He didn't show it to the stream.
Okay. I had it for a bit. I took it down.
Cool.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
You're good.
Back to Bilb.
Oh, I need to have little Bilbert's... Boom.
Oh, because it's like a pop-up.
So, are you going to let it happen, Bilbert?
Yeah.
All right, so the gargoyles just kind of leap on you and manacle you to this wall.
Uh-oh.
Ooh. Ooh.
Death by snoo-snoo.
Oh, I see that page.
Death by snoo-snoo.
Sloobla-da. Oh, that's a different page.
And you are, you're kind of, they kind of like bite into you and just let you kind of go unconscious, and you wake up chained to this wall.
Am I naked?
And when you and wake afraid. Up, when you wake up, you are there is a huge blue dragon staring at you.
Is that a euphemism?
Yes. and it hang on, come here.
It's a euphemism for blue balls.
blue balls are staring at me.
One time,
friends, you have awoken. Why don't we play a little game? Hey, Dragon, thanks for the host.
I love games. Have I mentioned I'm a good boy?
I'm a good boy.
He says, watch this. And the dragon kind of turns her head to an orc that is also chained to the wall. And she gazes at it. And you see...
Thanks, Dragon Trace.
From its the tips, its hands and its feet, it just kind of starts turning into stone and going... up its arms and over its shoulders, dragon. Until it's eventually turned into a statue. And she says, now! And she turns to you, Bilbert. Who would you like to pick next? Me to do next? Yourself? Or your lovely friend here?
You.
That is not a valid choice.
Can I roll... a sleight of hand to try and get out of my manacles? Is that something?
You certainly can try.
It's not going to happen.
It can happen.
Shit.
It didn't. You kind of struggle against to get out. She's like, I see you have some fight in you. You'll go first.
I'll go first. Fuck it.
She stares at you, and your hands kind of start crackling and turning to stone. But all of a sudden, a group of more harpers, what you recognize, burst into the room. and just the leader appears to be he just runs in screaming, "Blood of the Lady!" And he puts his ring out, and a huge wall of frost just kind of erupts from the ground and pushes the dragon's head up into the ceiling.
Oh, shit.
And just kind of crushes it and holds it there, and it growls out in rage. The other harpers kind of come up and release your manacles. The harpers start firing shots off on Imrith. And she's like, "Don't you get away, you dirty halfling!" And she's staring at you, trying to turn you into stone. You notice the stone has started receding, but has left scars on your hands of where the stone was. You spot she has a pretty good hoard. You think you could probably steal some gold, or she's pretty helpless right now, pinned to the ceiling. The guy with the ring is doing crazy shit. Like, he has this wall holding Imrith up, and some gargoyles tried to attack him, and he points the ring at them, and this whirlwind of, like, snow and ice just picks them up and slams them, impaling them on stalactites on the ceiling. and the whole room just drops probably, like, 50 degrees.
Uh-oh. Someone needs to get a heater installed.
Is this Storm from the London comic?
When, with me and, like, my halfling movement and all that stuff, am I able to get closer under the dragon? Do I see any weak spots that I can attack?
Yeah, you can easily get a shot in on her. And they didn't strip you of your daggers you brought.
Okay, they stripped me of everything but my daggers?
No, they didn't strip you of anything. They just chained you to a wall.
Okay.
You are completely
nude. Yeah.
I want to help the harpers.
Go ahead. Yeah, get a shot in.
Okay, I'm going to use...
It's getting scary.
There you go. Oh, yeah.
You got any music you can put on?
And you get a shot, and you just ram it into her nostril and rip it open, and blood starts coming down her face. She's like, "You won't get out of here alive!" And she kind of starts wriggling, and you see the ice wall cracking and breaking until it eventually starts falling apart, and she's getting loose. The other harpers are making a break for it, even the guy with the awesome ring. They start retracting. They're like, "Let's go!"
She's getting loose, Gilbert.
Come on.
Yeah, I'll bounce.
All right. So you and the harpers start escaping. The gargoyles aren't really sure whether to give chase or to help Imrith get out from the ice, but you guys manage to lose them and escape and return to Fondalen after a couple days travel, and are left with some scars and the glory of getting a hit on a ancient dragon.
Did I get a hat too?
Get a hat too.
Awesome.
from lids at the mall. Mm-hmm.
And that's swung by the lids.
And that's the end of your tale.
Where's your scar, Bilbert?
It's on my hand.
It says, your hand. I think the chug killed Harry.
Yeah, is he dead? Did he die?
Dragon and role player, how's it going? What we're doing right now is this is actually
I got some water. I'm good to go.
In their youth, it kind of These are little flashback stories they're telling our little pal.
I'm alive and well and ready to go again. I can do another chug right now. Try me.
That's a great tale.
See what happens.
But I must focus on my studies, and he returns up to the top, and he's like, "We'll continue tomorrow."
You tell the story, he just leaves? Rude. But
yeah, well, he's got to focus on story.
We're in a floating castle. It's not going to take us that long to get to this place. Like, come on. It's just the road.
It's going to take about 25, 26 days.
Is he going to use it against us, all these little stories we're telling? Is he going to dox us? Who's going to find our social security numbers?
You guys, you can bed down for the night, and we'll just blow through this.
Anyone want to get in my hut?
Is there anything you want to do? If you want to get in trouble, you kind of want to sneak around, see what's up there.
I kind of want to get in trouble.
I want to ask
Greyfear if he still has that keg of beer. I guess It's going to be a different keg of beer now than it was 5 years ago.
We drank it at the party. We drank it at the party.
That's right. Yeah, that's right.
He does not have
I'm going to cast Thaumaturgy because I just want to make a loud noise.
All right. What's the sound sound? Yeah.
It's going to sound like a cat purring really loudly.
Okay.
It's beautiful. Because I want to act like we're in a like a fighter plane in like the
1920s. All right.
What, are we on drugs?
Big fucking bomber.
I want to nonchalantly get the fuck away from Covell because he smells like shit.
Yeah, he does smell like shit. It's pretty bad. Actually. So yeah,
he smells the worst.
You smell
before
worst.
Before we bed down.
I can't even.
Before we bed down, I'm gonna cast a real boy spell, and I'll do remove curse if I can.
Yes, you can.
I'm trying to do it, but it's not touching me.
Well, that's fine. You'll get next. I know you have it. Covell.
I cast remove curse on Covell's ring.
All right. Covell, are you removing it with the remove curse?
Do I lose the benefits too?
Yes, you do.
No, I want to stink.
Okay.
I don't want you to stink.
I'm sorry.
The benefits aren't that good.
Yeah,
you know. The economy is bad, and this is a bad economy for this.
You're the reason we didn't have to fight a boss at the end of our last campaign.
Sorry, guys. I'm sticking with the stink.
Alright.
Anyone else cursed?
You guys want to kill him in his sleep?
I mean, what if we did, actually? What if we did kill him?
Oh my
whoa,
god.
Whoa. I think I rubbed off like way too hard on you guys in pain. Now. I don't suggest any of the shit that I used to, and you guys are fucking psychopaths.
I'm trying to kill your war bear.
The fact that I have to be the voice of reason in this group is absurd.
I think it's because Greyfear's back and he's trying to do the right thing.
I don't think we should kill the giant yet.
Oh, no, I meant kill Covell.
I meant kill Covell.
So you guys, is there anything else you want to do before you bed down?
I want to explore.
Just to confirm, if Covell removes the ring, he doesn't smell anymore, right?
No, he still smells.
No, he still smells.
Even if I do the remove curse thing?
Only if he lets you do remove curse. It sounds like he's not going to let you.
Tell me what the benefit of the ring was again, Kellen.
+1 to all your saves.
All my saves?
Where's his stink gland? Can we extract that from his body?
It is a magical stink that is emanating from every pore of his body.
I have daggers.
It's metachlorine.
What's the effect of the stink?
He has a penalty disadvantage on charisma checks.
Which I already have awful charisma. I'm already -1.
I mean, yes, I can.
This is not a good thing.
Could he potentially be immune to my stinking cloud if he's in it?
He is not.
Oh, really? You think he'd be smelly enough that he could like walk in it?
It's like different smells. Like you know when you're in the bedroom.
It's like apples and oranges. Man.
You're in the bedroom.
You're under the blankets and you fart and then you put it up and you sniff it because it smells good. Someone else farts and then covers your head with their fart, it's horrible. It's not the same.
I got you.
So it's basically like Covell, it doesn't bother him too much because it's like smelling his own farts. He's just craving some hard-boiled eggs. That's the only thing.
It's some mitochondrial DNA shit. It's got to be from you.
Yeah.
Oh.
I'm keeping it for now. I might change my mind.
Okay. God damn it. All right, fine.
Cool. So you guys doing anything else or are you bedding down?
We'll kill him.
I want to explore.
You want to explore? How are you exploring?
I want to figure out how to make the steps come down.
Okay, how are you figuring it out?
Anything that looks like it could be manipulated in any way I touch.
Okay, roll me an investigation to search the room for things to touch to bring the stairs.
I'm loving this. Harry's running around touching shit in the room.
I'm just like, he's just like, touch it.
Like Toys R Us.
The stat. Oh, where's your? Can I get your perception? Or yeah, investigation. So with that 14, the statue actually on the right, his crotch almost looks like a lever is there that you can pull down on.
Okay, I go and tug on his crotch as hard as I can.
All right, so you tug on it, and you use all your weight and just start yanking on it as hard as you can, but nothing happens.
Wait, I'm gonna tug on it.
But
so do I. I jump.
I need the rest of you to roll. Perception.
You got it.
Does my Bilbert count?
Already 25? Did. So Bilbert, as he's tugging on the statue's crotch, like as hard as he can, trying to
roll for arousal,
you notice the statue's mouth just slightly turns into a smile.
Oh, he likes it.
Ah, Jesus.
So what happens if I go over and tug as hard as I can on Stone crotch?
He looks even happier.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to break it off.
I feel sick. Anymore. I feel sick right now.
You can't break it off. It's like pretty girthy.
I'm pretty girthy too.
I'm uncomfortable.
I don't know.
All right. I'm extraordinarily comfortable right now.
Are you guys doing anything? Harry, that was your best guess at getting the cloud stairs to appear, but does not work.
Okay, then I go to sleep.
I'm going to spoon with Harry and go to sleep.
Anyone want in the small, tiny hut?
I'll sleep.
I'm good. I'm going to go back to the chair. I'm sleeping on the chair.
Omi's got his little tiny hut up.
Tiny hut drawn in.
Everyone does
get on in.
Covell, I need you to roll me a
D10. Oh, he left. All right, D10. Here comes. Here comes everybody. That'd be real stinky.
Oh!
Wow. 2,000 gold in the chat.
All right. 10. All right. So, as you kind of wake up in the morning, the stench seems to have just disappeared. Like, you don't smell good. Like, you still smell like Covell, but not horrible Covell. oh, God. One of your eyes, you just, you cannot see out of.
What?
It's kind of grayed over. And you can't
look what
see
you
out
did,
of it
Spate.
Anymore.
It's turning him into a dead thing.
And you have from now on you will have disadvantage on perception checks.
Oh,
let me know when you want me to.
Yeah, I'm ready to remove this fucking curse.
Did he get a pink eye?
Let him have it. Let him have it.
Let me roll it. Also, before I roll it, how much is your vision worth?
Nice. I like it.
Yeah, it was free before, but now you're asking. So.
It's a good question.
That's how old friends treat each other, huh? I see how it is.
Yep.
I don't know if I have anything.
Surely you got something.
I will.
You sure you want to give up the plus one to all your saves?
It's
pretty big.
I only have one eye now.
Until tomorrow.
You assume.
Yeah.
Maybe he'll just lose the next eye tomorrow.
Yep.
I hate you so much, Catelyn.
Oh my god, if he's blind in the rest of the game.
Wait.
Look how happy Spade is right now.
Does this also mean that the bear is blind as well when he's the bear?
Yes.
Oh, you gotta fucking get rid of that shit.
No, it's just perception. You don't need that when fighting. You just
actually
need to know if you're gonna get in a fight.
But you can still kill him, guys.
I've got sick perception, so don't worry about it.
I craft then Covell a sweet ass motherfucking eye patch. And give it.
Oh shit!
I say you're my boy, Blue. Don't let that son of a bitch, greedy asshole, touch you.
I can't wait till tomorrow. It's gonna.
I'm gonna keep it for at least one more day.
Oh,
is this the same eye patch that I stole from Covell years ago? Is it the same eye patch I stole from?
You turned that in, right?
I
honestly couldn't tell you what I did with it.
Actually, nothing. Shut up, Captain.
I need you.
No.
I need you to roll a D100 for me again.
D100.
Yes, sir. Let me know what you get.
14.
All right. All right, cool.
Well, he's dead.
That's all I needed.
He's dead.
So Zephyros comes down. And he greets you again, Griefier. Hello, young friend. May I have my seat? And he bends down to give you a pat.
Can I have another pet? Oh, good.
And he picks you up and drops you on the table. He says, now, another tale.
I'd like to tell you my tale.
All right, Griefier.
I would like to have you... I'd like to have the DM tell you my tale.
Yeah, sorry. boop. So, Griefier. You
what up, son?
Remember back in the time.
I want to sit on his lap.
When you, all right, he let you. He's happy.
Yeah.
So great. Peter, yeah, awesome. You remember a few years back while you were traveling to the Sword Coast, you kind of came the way by north, and you got captured by some yak folk, and they made you their slave.
Look at that picture.
Yakety yak. Don't talk.
By the way, right when you started telling the story, a huge bolt of thunder just happened outside.
Oh,
so. Oh shit!
Oh, oh man!
So
thunder rolled by Keith, Toby Keith.
You've been captive with Helani. She claims that she is a moon elf princess. You guys. On this particular day where the story takes place, you guys are cleaning some clay vessels. Lani is not exactly the least clumsy person in the room, and she drops and breaks one accidentally. One of the yak folks' wives is enraged. You know that this means that a whipping or worse is about to take place when she barges in and demands to know who did it. Oh, she just barges in, demands to know who did it. What are you going to do?
Who done it? Say, who I'm a good it? Boy. Say, I'm a good boy.
I've always been a good boy. And I'm still a good boy today. I don't know who did it.
All right. She says, well? And she looks at Helani and she starts kind of quivering and crying. She doesn't.
She's been a good girl. She's always been a good girl.
Are you saying you did this, Drow?
I forgot you were black. You're screwed.
No, goddamn.
He's a Drow. He's not black. Yeah. Two different things.
I'm obsidian. Yeah. All right, please.
He's different than me, and that's all
one
that matters.
Me. Yeah, one lives underground and kidnaps people, and is
and one is a real
and worships
person.
Spiders.
One's a real.
Yeah. All right.
Jesus.
Right,
neither
cool.
of us know, oh. and neither of us have done this. So please, fuck off.
I quit.
She comes to you and she's like, "Looks like you're being punished," and she reaches up her hand to strike you.
And I give her the shocker before she can get me.
roll me a dex. Give her that yakish shocker.
At advantage?
No.
Stealth.
If anything, at disadvantage. Nope.
Give her a yakker.
You try, but as she's going to strike you and you're going to shock her, a fire giant kind of barges in the room.
Jesus.
Yeah. Says, Cinderhild, which you know is the spoiled yakfolk princess.
Uh-huh.
She wants him down in Iron Slag. And the yakfolk queen kind of looks enraged and says, whatever. And he goes to motion and take you guys down to see her.
Well, let's go then, I guess. I don't have a choice.
All right.
I don't know.
As you enter the room, she's surrounded by some hobgoblin handmaidens, and she kind of hand waves them out of the way. Tell me everything you know about the outside world.
Why?
Well, I've always wanted to see it.
You're a princess. Why don't you go see it?
Do you think we could? Would you take me?
Well, I mean, you're in charge here, so either you're going to do it or we're not. I mean, I'm... you got the giant, bitch.
Says, well, I'm as much a prisoner as you. But, And it's just the three of you in the room. She says, you know, let's follow me. And she takes you to some big adamantine doors.
Okay.
And she whispers a phrase to the guard. The phrase is chocolate ice cream. The doors open up, and you guys manage to creep out.
I'm so distracted by Harry's little partner right now.
We got a hug with you or something.
Yeah. Beautiful bow tie.
I'm so cute.
So you guys, you sneak out.
Wait, hold on, hang on.
So you guys quickly get tracked down. You hear some hellhounds on your back as they
I see a hellhound right now.
Yeah, that's it.
Fucking bug.
As you guys are running, you manage to come to a waterfall that you can. You figure you can either take your chances and jump in the water. All right, so yeah, give me a dex check. Oof. All right. So you jump into the water, but you get sucked deep into the waterfall, and you start suffocating slightly, and you nearly drown. But Cinderhild runs, dives down, and picks you up, and you feel her wet.
Grossness. What did she roll?
Yeah. She's good. She rescues you. And she says, "Thank you for getting me out of there. Go be free. You've earned it." And due to your near drowning, you have a fear of water from now on, just to remember in the future.
That's it.
And you managed to escape from slavery and headed towards
the rest of my life
towards the Sword Coast, and eventually met up with these chumps.
Yeah.
There you go.
Tough times. I really hate
you should stay there.
This is the reason why I really hate authority and water.
Yep.
I mean, classic. I wanted to have a create water spell, but I was just like, fuck that shit.
All right. He does the same thing. He says, "Thank you. Oh, I haven't fed you yet." And he runs back upstairs and he gets you a, down with a, what? Who's running upstairs?
Is there any way for us to, like, get news of what's happening in the world while we're up here and on Cloud 9?
Whatever you can see down below from 1,000 feet up.
This is Cloud 8, so I'm not sure.
The world is happening.
Cloud 7.3.
Yep. So, he goes up and Zephyros returns with a huge egg. And he just kind of puts down a giant pan on the ground. And he cracks open the egg and slams it down on it. And he pulls a book out from beneath his robes and kind of flicks through it. And he reads for a second. He says, "Ah." And then he just holds his hand out. And a cone of flame just erupts underneath the pan and starts cooking the egg. And he cooks it. And he says, "There, dig in. Is that enough for you? For the six of you?" And it's probably enough for 10 of you, to be honest.
Mm-hmm. I go to eat some, but I'm really having a problem with my depth perception today, and I'm having a hard time getting.
Somebody's a type.
Are you like sticking the? Yeah. Are you like sticking the pizza fork in your jaw and missing your mouth?
Yeah, exactly.
Crying.
Uh-huh. Cool. So he returns back upstairs to navigate as normal. You guys can continue throughout your day. Do you want to do anything or just sleep again?
I'm afraid to go to sleep now.
Put the shape up.
Yeah. All right.
Anyone want in the tent?
So he pops.
Yeah.
Now I'm jumping back on that chair. It's so comfortable.
Yeah. All right.
Hey, you want to cuddle with me on the chair, man? It's comfy.
No, I'm going to tiny hill.
Okay.
No.
So you guys, are you doing anything shenanigans, or just letting the next day come?
I'm gonna go pull on this penis.
You tug on it some more. Nothing happens.
Okay, go back.
Gotta play the long game. Long game.
Yep.
Actually, so, wait. I want to do one more check of the room.
Okay, go for it. Give me an investigation.
Yep. And coming right up. Coming right up. And it's a load.
I'm gonna do the same.
You know. Yeah. All right, yeah. You are not good. Neither of you find anything. You're not no good. Better leads than the bulge.
What about that?
I just found out this chair really is.
You notice that the statue on the other side...
With his one eye.
Yeah, you're disadvantaged.
Oh. You got them. You got them.
You're fine. Never mind. That's investigation. It's not perception.
Yeah.
Does those have anything to do
that
with
the other statue has a matching bulge to the one that Harry's been
messing
with. I look at Kavan and be like, I'll rub mine, you rub yours.
I'm gonna get come toward the key.
What the hell's happening right now?
So
in
you
this
better
game?
Start tugging on these
be
statues.
Be careful, Kavan. You've got problems with depth perception. You might hit yourself in the face with the giant bulge.
are we gonna fight anybody? This game,
so
what's
you
going
start
on?
Tugging and tugging and tugging.
This is about the story.
Greyfear, Omi, and Bilbert, as you see them tugging on these statues, you notice the room just gets like a couple degrees warmer, and both statues kind of smile warm. That's it.
I'm getting a little. I'm feeling something, you guys.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, keep doing that, and I'm gonna sneak around and ring the doorbell.
There is no doorbell. Bilbert, you can't actually reach it. Okay.
I throw one of my ball bearings into his doorbell.
He just bounces off. No, okay.
God damn it.
So, you guys.
Our DM is no fun. He won't let us ring the doorbell. God damn it.
I'm just saying these are 40-foot tall statues and a little tiny ball bearing isn't going
to ring the doorbell.
I'm right. Trying to make him really
get
happy.
Get those spike boys out.
So you guys rest up for the night, or are you doing any more shenanigans?
I'm just sleeping.
Sleeping. I'll
okay,
sleep.
Cool. Kavel, I need a D10 from you.
Seven.
Good to know.
I do have a question while we're hanging out. Am I my tinker's tools? Able to be working on using taking one of my pythons and trying to shape it into a slingshot with some of my.
Tools.
String or something.
Tinkler.
With your tinker tools. Tinker tools are more for making like small mechanical objects, but I will let it slide. Go ahead and roll me intelligence to try and make a sling.
There you are.
Okay. Let me see. That's saving throw, but
oh shit! Sorry.
That's fine. It's 14 instead of 20. So you manage to fiddle around, but don't make anything of real worth. But you don't lose anything out of it either.
Okay.
All right. So Kavel, when you wake up, your eye, you notice it has cleared. You start feeling like this as you've started like kind of coughing a bit, and your cough has turned into kind of bit of mad laughter.
Guys, let's kill him.
Greyfear, you recognize these symptoms. You've seen it before. This is cackle fever.
I've seen it.
Cackle fever!
While in the grips of the disease, victims frequently succumb to fits of mad laughter.
Yep.
It goes by the nickname of the Shrieks.
Luckily, we can.
And speaking of which, Kavel, I need a con save from you. What were you saying, Greyfear?
I was going to say, luckily, we can kind of figure from the effects of this ring that this will only last a day.
Okay.
So what do you want to do, Kavel?
Yeah, you're just kind of chuckling. You don't. You're good.
Spate's gonna be back with some madness, I know.
And I just in between fits of laughter, I just hold my hand up to I take my ring off and I throw it at Greyfear. Say, get rid of this thing.
Can I dodge?
What
do I roll for a dodge?
What are you dodging?
The ring. I don't want anything to do with it.
Well, I threw that. You would take the curse off of it.
Dude, the curse is on you.
Cavell, you need to roll an attack, I guess, if he's trying to dodge it. Just do a ranged attack with your, like, any of your ranged weapons.
This is going to turn out awesome.
All right, cool. So make sure you add that back, too. He pegs you with a ring, hits you square in the chest.
But I didn't get a... What?
He made an attack against your armor class. That's your dodge. He pegs you in the chest.
We take 4. Damn.
No, you don't take any damage. He just pegs you in the chest. It's a ring. Mm-hmm. It just bounces off your chain shirt.
Yep. Okay, cool. I'm putting the ring in my bag.
Remove the curse, Graythier.
Right, Graythier's got some shit going on in his life.
How many more days do we have until we're there?
It has been 4 days. You got about 23 left.
Okay. I want to hear some more stories about people's lives. We'll talk about the curse later.
God damn it.
All right. Harry.
Fucking dick.
Love it. Harry. I love it.
Yes.
You're the last one left. Zephyrus pops back down. He has a, it looks like a snake that he's curled up and skinned and split open. And he sets it down on the table. He's like, a meal for you, my friends.
I eat it.
All right. It is quite good. Still one of the better meals you've had. Is everyone eating it, I assume?
Yeah.
Well, I'll take a bite. Hell yeah.
Chewing it.
So, Harry, you kind of pop up. You're the last to go to entertain this guy. You harken back to when you were very small. I have one question.
Would this giant be considered a commoner?
No. Why?
From my character sheet.
Okay. He's not a commoner. No. Big magical giants in castles floating on clouds are typically not commoners.
So he's in his own society.
Well, the thing is, he's listening to my story, and I may or may not have a heart of darkness.
No.
So
it does not apply here.
I'm just going to leave that under wraps for now. Leave the audience in suspicion of what the fuck that means.
So,
don't reveal the hand.
When you were young and excited, you followed this group called the Grey Hands. They were known defenders of Waterdeep, but typically they were only called on in the most dire of situations, as the collateral damage from the Grey Hands excursions was typically quite extensive.
You mean like my collateral damage that I normally applied?
It kind of inspired you. you knew tales of them, and when you heard that they needed a torchbearer when they made an expedition into the Undermountain, you were the first to like sign up and go. You were a very eager little boy. So the members of them, just to kind of give you background on the Grey Hands, were Asper, who was a petite and beautiful but feisty human. She was always up for a fight. Carolus, the half-elf sorceress, and she had wild, curly red hair and flashing green eyes.
I hung around with a lot of hotties back in my day.
Yeah, she thought you were cute. Meliantor, he's a cunning wizard with long braided brown hair, sea green eyes, and an impish smile. She wore practical clothing, and scrolls could be seen kind of popping out of all of her. From underneath her pockets, or popping out of her pockets in her cloak. Harshnag was a frost giant, and all the Water Davians pretty much tended to use him as an indicator that their neighborhood was about to become a war zone. whenever they saw him, they typically got out of the area as fast as possible. And then finally, there was Jardwin, the leader of the party. He was a stocky, muscular guy with some shoulder-length black hair, and his skin was a grayish hue. He was pretty ruthless and indomitable, And he always met resistance with lethal force.
He had
legendary
notes.
Concentration. So you, since you're the torchbearer, you had to go first into the dungeon.
Okay.
I need you to make a perception check as you go in the dungeon.
Okay.
What was that? What the fuck was that?
Perception check.
Give me that perception, boy. All right, so as you walk in, almost within the first 5 feet, a pit trap just opens up, and you fall down into the pit. And the sound of that kind of crash as it opens.
Okay.
There is a bunch of kind of cultists erupt from around the corner, and a mind flayer, which is kind of like this humanoid with an octopus head, pops out of a side door and just ambush the entire group that you're supposed to be holding a torch for coming in, and kind of catches them off guard. So you're still in the pit, and while you're in the pit, Harshnag actually jumps down into the pit, picks you up, throws you on his back, and hops back up. And they begin fighting all the cultists and the mind flayer, and a lot of, as they have gone on, they're easily handling the cultists left and right, and you see
with one, my assistance though, because like we know I'm pretty
absolutely DM, and you see
we all know I'm pretty...
you see a cultist kind of out of the corner of your eye. It feels like Harshnag has not detected him, and he's just getting ready to throw a dagger straight at him, but you have noticed
I throw my body in front of the dagger.
Ooh. So the dagger flies up and it starts going straight towards Harshnag's eye. But you manage to leap in front, maybe. Roll a reflex.
Well, I'm going to attempt to catch it.
Or a dex. Oh, you're trying to catch it. Roll me a dex
save.
Yeah, I'm
trying to catch the dagger. Yeah,
gotcha.
Okay.
Roll me a dex save.
I'm trying to be badass.
Do it, Harry.
Or acrobatics.
There you go.
Yep.
Do it.
Ooh. Hang on. Let me look at acrobatics. Okay, no. This is the fucking story of ages.
So you jump out and the dagger comes up and you manage to catch it, but
can I catch it and throw it back while in momentum, like at him?
No. Oh. The fact that I'm even letting you catch it in the first, the dagger kind of goes in and you manage to grab it and it slices into your hand, dealing a small amount of damage. But you manage to catch it right as it about goes into Harshnag's eye, and he turns up to you and go, "Thanks, little buddy." And he takes his huge hammer and just slams it down on the cultist that threw it, and just splatters him all over the ground. And the fight ensues. They manage to push him back, and the mind flayer escapes. But you guys.
So basically, this is just a story about whenever I was with a much cooler party that did
pretty
better
much
thing.
Yeah, this is what you
the party
to.
I was. Yeah.
So you guys kind of finish
it. Yeah, it's all been downhill from this point.
Kind of clear
around with a bunch of halflings and bear.
They adeptly handled the dungeon, the likes of which you have never seen again,
and never will. You'll never see that again.
Harshnag has kind of held you the whole time on his back, and he pulls out, and you guys get out of the cavern.
He pulls out,
and you guys, he says, "Thanks, little buddy. I owe you one." And you guys kind of separate ways. The Grey Hands end up getting sent on another mission, and you never actually got a chance to work with them again, but you've treasured the moment.
You find them on LinkedIn someday.
Does he truly treasure anything at all?
No.
His last login was really a depressing day.
I forgot to put your little. There you go.
I hear like evil
There's
voices
there.
In my brain.
He's
the
big
night
boy.
When I sleep.
This is the Grey Hands. That's a picture of them. Just so you guys.
Oh, okay.
Can...
Mm-hmm. Howdy.
That's it. There you go. All right.
Oh.
And that is the last of the tales. And he says, thank you. A fine tale. Fine tale indeed. But I believe I need to focus on our continued traveling.
Yeah, you need to speed it up there, fucking giant boy. Come on.
Mm-hmm.
I asked the giant boy again if I could more of the castle.
No, I'm afraid it's far too dangerous for little folk like you.
Can I attempt to persuade him to let me see more of the cast?
Can we ride along with him? Can we take a tour with him? Like, we don't want to go alone.
You can certainly try to persuade him.
Yes, I want to do that.
I want to.
At least show us where the bathrooms are. Jesus.
Oh my god. Let's all try to persuade it to her.
I can do it. I got a good persuasion here. Covell's got
it. Covell's got it.
Covell's got it. We just want a little tour. That's all. That's all we ask. Oh, sorry, Omi. How are you asking?
He made me smelly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just say, Abby. I see these stairs come up and down like I'm kind of like a horror show strip mall where the escalator comes and goes, and I set up this tiny hut every night. Sometimes my party shows up. I just want a tour. I want to know where the fucking bathroom is. I'm sick of pissing my pants.
Fair enough. Well, the bathroom is there, and he points to the edge of the cloud. He's like, I just pee off there.
So that's what I showered in last night. Oh,
that was that like, isolated thunderstorm. Okay.
He kind of puts his hand in his chin. He's like, fine. Perhaps a tour is appropriate. And he says, well, this is the first floor. And he gestures around. These braziers on the corners, I cast continual flame on them, so that's why they're always lit, and you never get to sleep in the dark.
That's rude.
Up here, and he kind of, you can see just the slightest gesture, and the stairs kind of billow up and appear. And he says, well, up here, and he takes you up through the 20-foot hole in the ceiling. He says, this is my bedroom, and inside it you see some slender windows, and they're set with panes of stained glass. There's a giant-sized bed and an enormous wooden chest. There's some stone shelves protruding from the walls at, you estimate, 20, 40, and 60 feet high. It looks like there are a bunch of giant journals up there. And then about 10 feet above the floor you see an orb just kind of floating there.
Shiny.
Yep.
Who's there?
And then, are we all in this room now?
Yeah, you are.
Put us there?
Don't worry about the map. Just use your mind's
not
eye.
Not that I know it exists or anything.
Just use your mind's eye.
Can you put us there?
My mind's eye.
Just
over.
Use your mind's eye.
Come on!
I gotta ask our friend the giant if we can... I know he said just to pee off the edge of it, but can we take a bathroom break?
Yes, real life bathroom break.
Settle DM.
Is there a difference?
Is there
a BRB?
Oh, let's do the last room and then you can go pee.
Yeah, okay, last room.
The highest level of the tower, as he takes you up there, has some open archways set into the walls, and there are four griffins sitting there, and they have made nests. At this time, it looks like there's three of them, but one nest is missing. Someone? That's it. He's like, these are my griffins. They're my pets. Huh? And he kind of bends down and pets one. You hear like a weird purring.
Does it sound like this?
Yes, exactly. All right, guys.
Wait. I know I said I gotta pee, but I gotta ask this question. It's important. Can I ask I'll just ask. Can we ride those griffins, my dude?
Oh, I wouldn't recommend it.
No, I'm not asking if you'd recommend it, but I'm asking if we can.
Well, as the voices from the other planes have often told me, you can certainly try.
Hey, you guys.
I would like to watch Grey Dude try.
No, they're way too small. They're like house cats compared to him.
Oh, okay.
Oh. So that means Omi can ride them, I guess.
Oh, you all could easily ride them.
No, I meant Grey Dude.
He's just huge.
I love watching him do that.
I'm just
looking at my imaginary non-existent characters. I don't have a real person. And I noticed that there's no handle animal on it anywhere, so I am not going to ride a griffin.
All right, cool. Well, let's take a little break, guys. We're going to be right back. We're going to go pee and leave our bladders, make more room for beer. We'll be right back. See you soon.
Spades up to something. Come back.
All right, we're back. Harry is still out, but we figured we'll continue.
He must be pooping.
Oh, the epic bathroom break. Yeah, he's probably pooping.
He's probably taking a poop.
Yep. So
we don't know.
So I don't know if you guys saw while you were away. Spate has bequeathed a gift upon the party.
We can't believe that worked. Spate, you're too kind. I was.
You get my piece of magic item, I get a cursed item. Spate, you son of a bitch.
Oh, okay. Wow! Oh, there you go. There you go. Oh, there you go.
I can't believe it.
You're
now.
Fucking dead to me, Spate.
Oh, dude, that's too kind. That's too kind. I was just kidding about the thing, man.
What's going on?
Spate,
no, he's a low down, dirty son of a bitch.
What did he give us?
He didn't give us anything. He gave me some.
He gave us an encounter.
Spate makes me chug a fucking IPA. And he gives someone else. He gives someone else a magical item.
Definitely right. He,
what the hell is this?
He says,
my name's even easier to spell. Spate, right, motherfucker.
So Zephyros kind of sets you guys down on the ground. He's like, you know what? Why don't you spend time with Titus, Mildred, and Jessica?
Jessica. The Griffins.
They're kind. I'll be back. I need to adjust our course down in my chambers. I'll be back. Oh, cool. And he hops downstairs on the stairs, and the stairs disappear. And there's a big 20-foot wide pit, and he drops you off there. And as he leaves, you notice the griffins, which were just fawning over Zephyros, suddenly get a little more aggressive.
Oh, I knew.
I'm going back down. I'm going down. I'm going
crouch
down.
Up, and their feathers
using,
are rising
I'm
up.
Using, I'm using my silk rope. I have a few feet of it.
I'm going to approach one of the, I'm going to protect
Mildred. No fucking way.
Okay.
Oh, that didn't go very well.
You can't animal handle a griffin anyway, because they aren't animals.
Well, then I'm not approaching them.
What are they? Mad? Are they magical creatures?
Yes, they are.
Magic. Chimera.
Alright.
Oh, heavens. Oh, Dad Skittles, you're the best. I see you trying to make me anime.
I'm going to walk towards them. I'm going to walk towards them. Slowly. Slowly.
Alright, cool.
Slowly.
There we
I'm
go.
Right
well,
next
hang
to
on.
Him.
Actually,
I feel Siri, good about it. Oh, okay.
I'm gonna lock you guys. I need everyone to roll initiative right now before.
Oh fuck.
Oh, you gotta tell baby Greyfear about the initiative.
I already did.
I got.
Oh, he gets it. It's
well, it's easier to roll initiative if I can see my character on this wall here.
Up in the
air.
He's
the
fucking these griffins. Did you just spawn these in? Oh my god.
No, they were there.
Well, I mean, like. As thanks. Enemies.
Oh, I'm rolling. Hold on.
I mean, Jesus. They're there.
Oh, girl. Oh, girl.
What am I gonna do?
Fucking initiative my ass off.
They look cute. You know, it's hard to know what I want to do here. Damn.
Hey, Catelyn. Take the 6.99, because I got the advantage.
Okay.
What are you guys doing here on this roll? Anyone share what their plan is here?
All right.
No idea.
Harry, you are up first.
What you was guys,
the action that you took?
You fucking guys.
So, griffins are 190% aggressive.
They are acting aggressive. They're just kind of crouched down. You know when a cat, like, sees it's getting ready to pounce on you? Kind of that vibe.
So speaks to animals won't work with these guys?
You're also aware that...
They're not animals.
Zephyros fawns over them and treats them like his babies.
Yeah, and he's been really good to us, so let's...
Yeah, let's not piss off the giant, the flying castle that we are in.
No!
Oh, Harry, the fireball! Harry, what
are where are you casting it?
I have to ask what we were doing, Harry.
Cast it out the window.
Too late. Please right miss. There. All right.
Please miss. Harry, what's going on here? Harry.
So, like...
Please, go. Jesus.
Oh my god.
They didn't even attack
like right here.
Bait did so much damage with that.
He's mad because Greyfear got the magic item.
He is. Right.
So, you need to make a dex saving throw?
Who, me?
No, the griffin.
Everybody was like telling things, and I just was casting fireball the entire time. Like, I didn't care what anybody had to say.
Alright.
We're doing it. We've lost our friend, the giant.
Well,
Harry's gone. We're throwing Harry.
Grapple Harry and throw him overboard.
All right. So one of them makes it, and the other two
fail.
One
of them will survive.
Jesus Christ. Well, there's four nests, so there's only three griffins. Obviously, he's used to losing them, so...
It's all right, fine. Cool.
Maybe the other one's flying around. And...
You just light up the room, and all the the nests kind of catch on fire. They're just kind of burning. It's not like a raging fire that will do more damage. Oh, I heard something. Maybe why?
Wait, what?
Somebody. Hang on.
Spate, damn it! Spate!
Oh, spate, yes!
Think of the children!
Wait, what did Spate do? I didn't see.
He donated $10 more.
He killed your character off.
Oh, man. Jesus. Thank you, Spate. We love you.
Is that another check?
Alright, Harry, that is your turn. Greyfear, you're up. A giant fireball just burned all the griffins. They all look like they're still pretty strong.
I wish we could, Evie.
They look like they're still very strong.
Meaning none of them are bloody.
Wait, none of them are low? After taking two of them took 25?
None of them are bloody.
Oh, no.
We're big boys now. I'm not sure if goblins at you with 6 hit points.
Should I fart or not?
I'm gonna move.
And just so you guys know, not every encounter needs to be a fight, but it can be.
Yeah, I'm gonna move behind Covell. I don't care how much he smells. I'm moving here.
If you make me roll initiative, I'm gonna roll a fireball. That's all. That's gonna
happen. Got any battle music?
Yeah.
I think that one Skittles is disappointed in me as a person overall, but that's okay.
Yeah. Let's see.
She knows I'm anime. That's all that matters.
Anime. Oh, are you talking Wednesday nights? Anime.
Wednesday night's animes. I'm gonna.
I'm shooting
the longbow at the griffin on the right because.
Oh Jesus!
I want to hit it.
I don't want to attack the griffins.
I think it's too late.
I do.
All right, my beer is poured for Spate's donation. Who else is chugging?
I'll drink to that.
Trogdor.
Ooh.
Spate. 10 to hit.
You're a gentleman.
That misses.
One time you are a scholar.
Bilbert.
how far of a drop is it to those levels below?
So it's an open hole all the way down. So it's about like an 80-foot drop probably. To the yeah. room below, and then probably another 120 feet to the room below that. So it's 200 feet straight down.
You're gonna break your ass legs.
I could totally shape into a spider. And
how long are my chains?
Your chains? Yeah, they're like 5 feet.
Oh, cool.
I've got a couple feet of rope as well.
I have 50 feet of rope. I have 50 feet of rope. I don't have anything to hook it to, and this place looks pretty...
Listen, I don't know why you're trying to escape down the side of it. They can fly. You know that, right?
No.
Let's hang down a rope.
They're just going to take off, and then Eagle Claw you while you can't do anything.
Eagle Claw!
Let's so see if they attack.
Don't be a dumbass and just...
Don't be a dumbass and just shoot fireballs willy-fucking-nilly. I'm a good boy. I don't do that shit.
Hold on.
I'm a good boy. 1 year of this campaign. And that
shout out to good boys.
Shit.
Paul went out to good boys worldwide.
Alright.
Gilbert, what you doing? What did you say you were doing on your action, Gilbert? I didn't ask you.
I said I was going to move and use my light weapon, so...
Or ranged.
Or maybe don't get right beside them either. Whatever.
I'm going to come right here.
Make your choices.
Yeah.
Don't be like, bad choices. I'm gonna attack with my rapier.
Who are you to freak about good choices, you son of a
bitch? I'm gonna use my sneak attack there.
Yeah. Tell dad. Oh, Jesus.
Dude, I don't like this. Let's.
And then I'm coming back.
I'm apologizing.
Well, dad's coming after I play.
Wait, so were you using your bonus action to, Oh, no, that's once per turn. So you cannot withdraw and sneak attack in the same round because they both take a bonus action.
Oh, they do.
One bonus action per round.
I thought my second hand was my bonus action.
So, oh yeah, you're right. Sorry, you're good. Okay. Disregard. Yep. Sneak attack is just like something you can do once per turn. Yep. Okay.
Bilbert, what do you think Covell smells like right now? Tacos or cheeseburgers?
He's bloody. All right, guys.
Hot dog Fire. Water.
Having turned around.
In New York or Chicago?
One. Well, I don't have a lot of hit points.
Chicago.
It has multi-attack. I don't have a lot of hit points. Not a lot of hit points.
Bites onto you and starts trying to claw at you.
Ooh, I don't have a lot of hit points.
It bites onto you, does 8 points of damage, misses with its claws. Griffin number 2 flies
over. They're coming in.
Lands behind you.
Diet.
Ooh, why are they all coming after me? There's four other
because you just unleashed a giant fireball that, like, wrecked them.
What'd they think was gonna happen if they prowl up on me?
I don't have one.
What'd they think I was gonna do? Did they not see the crazed look in my eye?
Maybe I just used your guys' expectation of a random encounter to make you think I was doing it right that moment.
Uh-oh.
You told me to roll initiative, which means Jake cast a fireball. It's basically
what
you're
saying. No! God damn it.
Initiative only means that you're taking turns based on your initiative.
To attack. It says, do you want to attack with a light weapon? Do you want to attack you with a heavy weapon?
It also says other.
Or do you want to attack?
It also says other.
Well, you know what? I don't have another. I have fireball.
Jake's
bites down on you and then proceeds to rake you and does another 22 points of damage to you.
Jesus Christ, I'm gonna heal your ass now.
how many is that?
Bifelicia.
And the first one did 8, right? Boom.
Bifelicia.
Alright, Harry is dangling
on. The party.
And then finally the third Griffin. Bilbert, you attacked it. Flies over to you. Actually, no. It flies out the window.
Hold up.
And disappears.
Bye!
Hold up.
Uh-oh.
I don't think that's good. Happy, guys.
I hope it's not getting the fourth one.
Did you see that Taylor healed the...
Yeah, we gotta heal.
Covell, it's your turn.
No, he's ignoring it.
Hey, Cat, we gotta heal.
We gotta heal.
He's
waiting.
People use commands to chat. Use it.
No, no, he's...
I'm not hearing the notification. It's weird.
Well, that's not your fault.
I'm looking.
Cool. You all heal 12 hit points. Harry, I gotcha.
Hey, I can't believe you're bailing out your degenerate boyfriend.
Oh, release some personal info. Covell, it's your turn.
Oh, yeah.
I don't want to attack them.
Bow, bow.
Oh, yeah.
Bow, what are you doing, Covell?
I'm trying to figure it out. I was going to cast Cure Wounds, but I didn't choose a spell at the beginning. I didn't know Harry was going to get his shit wrecked, so...
Well, that was really? For your first move, wasn't it? Hmm? This is your first move, never mind.
This is my first move, yeah. I'm staying right where I am. No, I'm going to dire shape or shape into a brown bear, but then I'm going to stay where I am.
That's good.
Okay. You turn into a little baby brown bear.
Hey, Omi.
Omi, what are you doing?
Come to us.
Is Covell done? You want? I'm up. Yeah. Am I gonna get hit if I move away?
Come to us.
Well, he's right near the baby boy.
It's true.
He will take an opportunity.
Oh my god, I'm so
Whether
nervous.
Or not he chooses to take it is another matter.
Come to us.
What I do?
You can also
is...
use a full round action to disengage.
Yeah, come to us.
I'm so nervous I cast Stinking Cloud.
Right?
On the two above.
Does Harry get a whiff of it too?
Yeah, and Harry gets caught in it.
Alright.
So they, 20...
It's
20
a
foot...
Radius?
Yeah, 20 by 20.
Jump the shark. We're jumping the shark this episode.
They all need a DC 17, otherwise they get poison damage.
Look at that.
There it
shark.
Is. There it is.
Look at that dead.
Woo!
Oh my god.
There it is.
This is my first time actually witnessing this.
Yeah, this is what happened.
All right. And they need to. What do they need to do? They need to roll a constitution saving throw?
Constitution. Yeah, constitution. Every round they're in the cloud. Or otherwise they can move.
Okay.
Nope.
This one is...
one passed.
There you go. Did someone pass? Harry, yep. Harry didn't pass, but the one did.
That status. Sick.
One of them did.
And,
I got real nervous and I sharted myself, and a cloud shot out the eagles and Harry. So, this is what you get. I tried to run over to you guys, but didn't work out.
Right, Harry, you're sick as well, right?
Yep.
Yeah, Harry's sick, but the other eagle ain't. But you can jump out, right?
Yeah, with attacks of opportunity that are kill me.
All right.
Oh my god.
Oh, sorry. Sorry. I'm kidding.
All right,
you'll
Harry.
Die, but it's fine.
You're a sick boy.
Shit.
All right. The bear's form.
Big Daddy's coming
and
down.
Big Daddy pops up.
Oh, Dad!
What's going on in here?
we lied to him. We said they attacked us first.
They did attack. Well, no,
I did a stinky.
No, they
did.
They
did not. Bilbert, I need you to do a deception for me.
Hey, I want to do a deception.
Yeah, he's.
Bilbert, you shouted it out.
No, Greyfear did.
No, oh, what's you got better deception than me. Do it.
All right, I have plus one.
I thought Bilbert zero. Layered it.
Nice.
There it is.
Okay, hang on.
I agreed with the lie. I was going with it for sure.
Well, I have plus zero on deception, so...
No, I'm happy how we rolled.
Me too!
I'll take it.
What happened, DM?
Hang on, I'm working on it.
No, now!
I need his character sheet. It's
Griffins
all
of Death Metal.
It's froze! You know what? you succeed.
Yes, I do.
21, I mean, that's a good roll.
That's pretty great.
And he says, Stephanie, Mildred, what are you doing?
Stephanie.
And he admonishes the griffins in the stinking cloud. So get out of there! I'm gonna have to give you a bath.
I don't think Stephanie was the name one of them before, was it?
It was Stephanie.
Was it always Stephanie?
Oh, dirty dealer, Cumulo Stinkus, please. That's so good. Oh my god.
Where as the music ends, you say that.
Oh, that's awesome.
All right. Let me just say here.
That's the best name I've ever
heard. So how you guys want to play this? I'll give you a little in-between rounds to do something.
I don't want to fight the griffins.
So we have to... We're already playing it off like they started it, so now do we have to demand that Harry gets medical attention since they caused it?
Well, go ahead and do initiatives again.
Okay.
If you make me roll initiative...
He's gonna light the fart cloud up. I guess we can't burn it
because I don't know what's happening here.
Shit, Harry, what's your health? Are you looking bad. Bad or good?
Bad.
All right.
How bad?
I'm gonna move.
Okay, I got.
What's everyone thinking? Oh, you guys have already rolled a bunch of shit. All
right. Asa's still owes Spade a chug.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Me too. Yeah, I'm sure that, I think that's, that chugging's affecting your judgment.
What am I supposed to do?
Impaired judgment. He paid for impaired judgment. I mean,
that's basically, yeah.
I mean, we're all sitting at home. He's not paying for the DUI. It's fine.
Yeah. All right. So, I gotta walk 10 feet to pass out tonight. We're good to go. All
right. Bilbert, you're up.
Damn.
Hey, what's his name? Zephyros?
Yep.
Hey, Zephyros.
Call him ZZ Top. That's his favorite name.
Hey, ZZ Top. Your Griffins of Death Metal attacked our buddy Harry, and I think it would be very nice if you guys could help us out with some medical attention. He's almost dead. Period.
He just kind of glares at you. It's like, I think I have more pressing things right now. You're trying to kill my babies.
Your babies are trying to kill us.
Sometimes they get a little feisty.
Yeah, and almost kill one of our friends.
Sometimes I get a little feisty if people get feisty towards me. It's just the way I am, giant.
You can try and persuade him.
This guy's lived with squirrels for a long time.
Bilbert.
Yeah, I'll try it.
I'm scared.
All right, he says, well, you make a good point. Ooh. Your friend's in bad shape, but... I'm not really skilled in the healing arts, so...
I got him, bro. Calm down.
Gray Fear, you're up.
Okay. I'm gonna cast healing words.
Okay. Alright. Plus six to Harry.
Ooh, come on, Harry. Get him a little uppity. And I want to talk to our giant friend and say, you know... We wouldn't have done anything to them, but they attacked us and you were gone. We didn't know what else to do. We thought we were going to die because your griffins are fucking awesome.
Roll me a deception at advantage since you've already convinced him that they are attacking you.
Okay.
Ooh. It's like deception and charisma are the same.
Ooh, nice.
He's like, I'm going to have to handle these naughty babies. And he goes down. And
he almost got a spit take.
Reaches down and he grabs both griffins by their wings, like the scruff of their neck, and reaches them up. And he's like, Stephanie, Mildred, you all need to chill out a bit. And he's standing above the stinking cloud, so it's not affecting him because his head is a full 35
so
feet above.
Huge.
Yeah. You go back to your nest and think about what you've done. And he just kind of chucks them and they go, Fwa-bam! Fwa-bam! And they slam back into their nest. And he sits there with his arms crossed.
Aw, that's cute.
Covell, it's your turn.
I just sit down on my haunches in bear form and I grunt. And I don't do it at all.
Both of the griffins sulk in their corner.
What about that third one?
Griffins owned again by humanoids.
Yeah, where'd the third one go?
He flew away because he didn't really kill him.
Oh, yeah, he's spooked. He got plenty.
Scared of a little halfling.
You should have read through, but
Harry, you rolled initiative. What are you going to do?
Yeah, what are you doing?
Don't. Oh, God.
It's in a fireball. Wrong out.
No! Jesus!
I'm going to walk out of this cloud.
Okay. Wait, you need to make a save first.
Okay. Attempt to do that.
Make a con save.
Try him.
I'm going to put him right there so you guys can see. There, I sent you some saving throws.
I clicked on it, but I don't know if it came up or not.
I'll do it for you. Boom. You do it! You're not sickened.
Perfect. Okay. With a little bit of frustration and obviously injury to myself, I'm going to be like, who keeps pets like these anyways? And I'm going to bed, and I'm going to walk or attempt to go down the steps created.
Okay, so the steps are about 5 feet tall every bit. So you can you can climb down easily. You just kind of got to let yourself down each step by step. It's not just like a walk down in a huff. You flop down in a huff.
Yeah, that's right. What I do.
Omi, it's your turn.
I look at big ZZ Top man. I say, did I do that? And I try to recite a little poem about how cute griffins are. So can I roll a performance?
Only if you give me the poem.
Yep.
Yes? Can I roll the performance first? Because I'm going to do that right now.
I think you need
On a 9? Okay. can I do a thing real quick?
Yes,
yeah,
do
please
it.
Do. The only way you can recite a poem is if you actually recite a poem.
Okay. This is called Dear Griffin.
Okay.
All I wish for are your wings, great, powerful, endless flights through the places that I would want to call home. Just me and my thoughts and the wind. All I ask is for your beak. And all I ask is for your claws. I know you're stinking, I know you're feathered, but I wanna be your friend.
He glances down at you, and with that nod, he's like, it'd probably be best if you went downstairs.
Oh, shit, damn it! Alright, I'm leaving. I jump off the cliff.
The steps are twice as tall as you are.
I'll just jump off the edge and kill myself.
Yeah?
No!
I'm trying to sing about this.
He's trying to be
Gilbert.
Glib.
Oh, okay. It's Gilbert.
Yeah, what's up?
Right.
Be careful. Greyfear has a resurrection spell, so I'm not afraid to kill you.
I'm not going to waste it on that.
We'll need so many diamonds for you to get more.
I use my rope to lasso Omi and stop him from doing something stupid.
Okay. Do you guys want to... Are you going to do anything else, or are you going to accept that he admonished the griffins and believed your lie?
I accept that I just trolled his ass.
I accept that we're all alive and
Hey! Yeah. Oh!
You guys defeated the griffin?
Yeah! Yeah!
Right.
Was something that happened.
Befriended
I'm
the
going
pinball.
To back into a barbarian.
Okay.
Can I go ahead and click wrong long rest in my bed quarters?
Nope.
You don't deserve long
you
rest.
Cannot.
You're grounded.
I think we're in big trouble right now.
You have to stay in big trouble.
You think we're in big trouble?
You have to stay at home like now.
It's only 300 gold worth.
Alright, hang on. Who's chugging with me for this? Anybody else? Or?
I'll join you.
I got you, fam.
DM, you can't get drunk.
Greyfear, I still owe you too, so don't forget that.
I'm not forgetting it. And also, Spate won't forget it either.
Okay.
Shot the wrong gun with the wrong ammunition.
I'll chug a cup of chili.
Yeah, do it.
No, I'm doing it.
I need to wake up homies. Anyways and falling asleep. Chugs
Harry, that was a great fireball.
Thanks.
It was great. It was honestly great.
It was really good.
It was.
Damn, Canis should get dry. Oh, sorry.
In a dreaming height, on grave dead bones, a branch where leaves conspicuously crept craven distance. Oh, I remember.
No, wait, did you choke yet?
Yeah, kind
I just choked. I'm doing it now.
This music's real scary.
I know, it makes me want to pee.
What music? Am I still playing music? Oh, I'm still playing music.
There's music playing. It's that scary. It's a Scary Boys.
It's
music.
Like dark on the screen, and we're.
Do.
Bum, bum, bum.
Alright, cool.
Bum.
So, managed to get away from attacking. Get away with attacking his prized pets, but are banished back to the first floor. And he says, "Baby, it's best you stay down here."
It's his fault, anyways. Fuck him.
Maybe it's best. Maybe it's best they stay up there.
Ooh, strong words here.
Yeah. Now we own the floor we're admonished to. Yes.
That's right. our house now.
Yeah, the prison is our house now. Yeah,
these are our jerk off statues.
Oh, Jesus!
Zing.
All right.
Alrighty.
So, you guys get banished down.
I'm checking out the dig. I'm checking out that bulge.
You're more than welcome. Yeah, you can play with that all you want.
I just want to look at it. I'm just looking at it. I'm just looking.
I'm trying to ensure that nothing is ever going to happen.
Well, don't try to ring
the
doorbell.
I'm going to go back to sleep. I'm sleeping on the chair again because I'm a good cat.
I'm going to go spoon with Omi.
Somebody spoon with
me. Thank you.
I'm lonely.
I'll make the time here.
I won't spoon you until you get rid of this curse.
I want to act like I'm independent, but I really want company.
I would spoon until you get rid of this curse, but I can't stop laughing.
Harry, please.
All right. So you guys camp. Go ahead and do your long rest.
Here's the tent.
Okay.
And probably 4 more days pass. He is not nearly your giant host. Is not nearly as friendly as he has been.
He's mad.
Yeah, I'm sure.
He's been bringing down. He still brings you guys food, but it's like kind of burnt and not as flavorful as it has been.
Can we talk to him about this?
Yeah, you certainly can.
The growler is gone. There's no more left.
The vape mom is gone.
And I just chugged. That was a prima. Pilsner, so it was pretty.
So, you guys Taylor, talk to him.
Taylor
in these,
is
in
so
these 4 days.
Right
are now. You are you saying anything to kind of try and improve his mood or?
Yeah. I
mean, he's still congenial. He's not, but he's not.
Can I offer to tell him another story?
Yes, you can.
That you don't have planned, but you set up right now.
Yeah, you can absolutely. Tell him another story.
Yeah, I would like to tell him the story of the squirrel.
Oh, please do. Add advantage, because he loves stories.
Mm-hmm. What do I need to roll again? Sorry, everybody was going...
You need to roll a... just do a charisma. Or a persuasion, whichever you choose.
Straight charisma.
And he pats you, Grayfear.
Do I get it at an advantage?
Yes, because he loves stories.
Good.
All right, yeah.
I can tell that his pats are...
Very well. Tell me about this. How do you pronounce it? Squirrel?
Squirrel.
Oh, Squirrel.
I love
the tiny folks language.
I like Omi's hut. That's a good-looking hut right there.
It is a good-looking hut.
All right. Harry, tell us about the squirrel.
Tell us about that. I don't have anything for him. This is some rough shit.
Come on, dude. Make up a story.
All right.
So, this one time.
Harry, I tell you what. How about I give you to next time, and you come up with a story then, and then you'll come back with a glorious story of the squirrel.
Perfect.
He's right, he's like, but not now. It looks like we have visitors. And As you can, you look through that kind of translucent curtain, and you can spot 9 very thin and lightly armored humans that are riding giant vultures. They land right in front of the door atop the cloud, whereupon they dismount. As they get closer, you can see that they are all appear to be human. They wear steel helms that cover their eyes and resemble stylized bird heads. One of them is equipped with a shoulder bag adorned with a smiling face.
Is he the comedian from The Watchmen?
Who knows?
I don't think that was the bird bird.
Well, this is...
I'm sneaking.
This is old giant boy's house, so he gets to be the one to deal with the guests, right?
You're correct.
Yes.
Not our house.
Nope. Not our problem.
All right.
Kat, I'm readying myself with my bow while I'm stealth.
Okay.
Wait, is the giant still here?
Yeah, he's hanging out.
What's going on? Fireball?
No. Only if it's whiskey. No real fireball.
So anyway, the humans with these masks enter the building. I'm just bringing them all in. Why not?
Jesus Christ.
They
all come in.
People coming on in.
Finally, they leave their vultures parked outside.
Looks like they're grouping up for fireball, though.
Yeah, a lot of vultures. Why do I have to be standing right there next to them? I don't want to be standing right there next to them.
I'm sorry?
I tried to move myself, but I'm locked.
Well, I locked it down to
keep everyone from goofing.
Yeah.
Some of us are a little click happy, and I don't know why.
I'm happy to be right here.
Blame Harry.
We like to explore.
All right. So,
Harry's head's going.
So they enter in. They say, "We." The one in the front kind of has a red hood and says, "I am Emrath, and this is my compatriot, Invan. We speak for our group here, and we are speaking on behalf of Yan Si Bin. We would like to see if you are interested in working together."
Is he addressing us or the giant?
The giant. They're basically ignoring the rest of you.
Okay.
Okay. I'm writing some notes down.
They say, "We've brought a gift," and he pulls a pouch out from his that he's carrying. He says, "This is a pouch of pixie dust, most rare. In exchange for your help of helping Yan Si Bin return the world to its primordial state, as it was at the dawn of history, before things got complicated. It would be much better for society if we can just kind of hit the reset button. What do you say?" He scratches his chin, Zephyros. He's like, "Well, I've come to trust and love my companions here. What do you think I should do?"
I draw my axe and just kind of lean on it, like, casually, and look at the guys in the red hoods. I think that sounds like a pretty fucking awful lot.
So, by reset, I'm going to speak as Hand of the Giant. By reset, he means...
Hand of the Giant.
He means wiping out humanity and everything else as we know it. Correct?
Are you asking Emrath or...
Emrath.
No, not in such a way. Yan Si Bin will ensure those loyal to his cause will be spared.
So what is his cause?
His cause is to return the world to its primordial state.
So if we're not loyal to wiping out all of humanity, then we're going to get wiped out with all of humanity, is what you're trying to say?
Oh, we are not wiping out humanity.
Sure. What do you consider the reset?
Well, it's a reset on... Yan Si Bin has many plans.
Has Yan Si Bin been prone to using stones and throwing them off of floating castles on unsuspecting people?
Oh, no, of course not. Okay. Why would you ask such a thing?
What's your play in this game? What's your plan?
Yeah, what has Yahtzee been actually doing? So why would I join his cause if he won't tell me what he's doing?
Yahtzee knows all.
He has a great plan, and it is not my place to question him. I am merely here to
help
great folks like yourself.
No, you don't have to question him. We want to question him.
Yeah. What's his plan? That's my question. I'm not going to sign up for something if I don't read the fine print. What's the plan?
I look back over my shoulder at Harry and say, "I think there's some evil that might need to be smote."
I give Covell the best wink he's ever seen.
And then I let them have their little boy moment, and then I look up to ZZ Top and I say, "Hey, ZZ Top, what's the deal here? Who are these people?"
It says, "I do not know. I've had many people contact me for their help."
How do you feel clearly, about them? What is this?
Clearly, they have set you an edge, and I trust your judgment. And he looks at the group of humans that have landed and made an audience, and he says, I'm not interested in your offer for a reset to the primordial age. My friends think it's unwise, and therefore I think it's unwise. I would prefer you make your leave, and please leave us alone." The human who's been speaking for the group, you can see his eyes kind of narrow. He says, "Very well. But you have made a foolish mistake. Best of luck to you."
Can I surprise Ron Fireball? Best of luck to
us. Expect us. And he kind of turns around and...
Can I surprise Ron Fireball? Surprise Ron Fireball?
Absolutely can.
Do it.
No, don't do it. Let them just let him go.
Hang on, wait. Everybody be quiet for a second. Covell, what should I do? Surprise Ron Fireball?
Fireball the fuck out of him.
Surprise Ron Fireball.
Alright.
Sure.
I just want to triple check.
Okay, so to be clear, our giant friend is on our side, right? Hmm. He thinks these are bad people.
These are bad people that all flew.
It's too late. I've already cast.
You're doing it? You're absolutely.
Oh my god.
Sorry, the enchant. Right here.
Scared enough.
I'm just triple checking. You want to do fine.
All right.
Okay. It is done.
Catelyn, WTF.
All right.
Don't worry about it. We're going.
Stat block.
We're doing it.
Scared.
Let me see.
I need them to roll Constitution.
Diet Skittles is real upset with me right now.
Yeah, thank you. Don't worry. Diet Skittles is not the only one.
I supported this one, Jake.
So you're
the only one.
They got con save? All right.
We need some freaking fight.
Two.
Spade's going to need money back because he tried to...
4, 5, 6.
Oh, I tried to scare. I didn't scare. Oh,
no. I'm sorry. Spade, I'll get that back to you.
No, he doesn't get it. He shouldn't get it.
You're passing it right in the middle of the group, right, Jake?
Yeah. So it looks to me like only one pass.
Yes. So let's get this real quick so people can cast a fireball right in the middle of them. This intense heat just engulfs the entire group, and they all just turn to ash as they collapse to the ground.
Oh, Jesus.
And nothing is left from them as their screams of pain and agony. Even Zephyros is a little taken aback. I'm like, oh my goodness.
They were
going to leave peacefully.
I look at him and I say, I have a couple small things, which you'll hear more in a story when I tell you. But if there's evil in this world, I feel compelled to purge it. And that's what you just saw was some motherfucking evil purging. But
how do you know they were evil?
What do you think reset the world back to primordial state? Leaving everybody as they are right now? Or killing them and uprooting their lives when they're doing nothing but living as families and friends and people? Just like,
aren't things terrible? Don't you... I mean, I can see their argument.
This is very philosophical here.
Things are terrible.
Hang on, everybody.
But murder is not the solution.
Shh.
Of innocent people.
Things you murdered them. They came here in peace.
Hey, hold on.
What makes you better than them?
What makes you better than them is that they did not come here in peace. They came here trying to recruit you, who's a very powerful person, a very respected person, to help kill innocent. But you were wise enough to say no.
I came to recruit you?
Well, yeah, but you recruited.
Are you going to burn me alive?
No, because you what you don't understand is, like, as soon as I let them leave here, they're going to go to the next powerful person. And eventually, a powerful person is going to say yes, because we let them go and recruit more people. So I have to...
Angrily that they were coming back.
I have to end this at the root. Whenever you want to kill weeds, you pull it out by the root. And that's what I just did. I just got rid of some weed.
Hey,
he kind of scratches his big wispy beard.
Can I buy some of their weed?
And he thinks, well, the planar beings did say you were the ones.
Ooh, wait,
you make a case.
You just watched me. Watched me kill like 13 fucking bad guys.
Roll a persuasion, Harry.
All right, persuasion. Here we go.
God, we're done.
Yes. Oh.
Persuasion. All right.
So, drop the mic, Harry.
Very well. You all are. Sometimes I think you might be more dangerous than the Gray Hands. Have you heard of them?
We're not friends.
They were travelers back in the time. Back
in
the day.
They may have shipped me a thing or two.
Nah, that makes a lot of sense. He says, very well. And he returns. He says, I must go return to my studies and steer the ship.
Can I have a pet before he goes away?
The vultures, there's still like a couple meandering around, but most of them flew away in the explosion.
Can we catch them? Trying to like catch one of them?
Yeah, you absolutely can.
How do I do that? What do I roll for that? Give me a vulture.
Give me a vulture. I want one.
I got a rope. Can I make it into a lasso?
Animal handling?
Yes, you can. You can with a dex to try and tie the note.
Okay. So dex.
Everything is pretty much incinerated clothes-wise, but they left behind some armor, and the bag is actually still the bag is still intact.
Ooh.
There you go.
Is Cavell visibly aroused by what I did?
No, I'm visibly disappointed because I was wanting a fight, not a...
I was wanting a fight!
So, amongst them, we'll do this after we go off. I'm just going to assume you guys loot their corpses, because you always do.
Yes.
There is a small pouch, which they offered as the gift. It seems to have about 10 pinches of pixie dust. One pinch of the pixie dust can actually substitute for the material components of any enchantment spell of third level or lower. It has some other magical effects, which I'll explain to you after the fact. It does stuff. Basically, you can gain some flying speed, like in Peter Pan. You can fall on... Bad things could happen. You can fall unconscious. Uh-oh, somebody's gone.
It was Bilbert.
Bilbert did.
He's coming back, I hope.
All Bilbert right. did a...
So,
escape.
Yeah, you can come invisible. It does all sorts of stuff. And then there's a smiling bag as well, which, as you open it up, it seems like your other bags of holding that you've seen, and it is a bag of holding as well. And then they all have gear. We'll figure this out after.
All of a sudden, my idea wasn't so bad, was it, guys?
Anything could have happened.
It depends. It depends on where they came from and who sent them.
Okay, they came from bad guys. We're good guys. We killed them. That's our job.
That's fine.
I'm not sure if I'm a good guy or not. I haven't figured that out yet.
We're good boys. We're good boys.
We're good boys.
But we're good boys. We're bad boys. We're boys nonetheless. But was it men? Was it men that sent them?
You guys are making me think I might be a bad boy.
Harry, Alestra, who's kind of been like, just kind of hanging out with you guys, observing. She comes up and puts a hand on your shoulder and. She whispers in your ear, and she's like, "That was the smartest decision you guys have made."
Ooh, there you go.
And I look back at her, like dead serious in her eyes, and be like, "No one,
no one what?
No one has ever said that to me before."
Thanks, Malestra.
Yeah.
Oh, Malestra. Hey, Catelyn.
All right. Yeah.
What do I need to do to chill with one of these vultures? Can I speak to animals? Maybe?
Oh, yes.
We are not bad boys, Galaxy Cat. You shush.
I might be a bad boy.
Galaxy Cat?
The darkness is taking me over.
You can do an animal handling.
Okay. Will speak with animals benefit me in any way?
Will what?
Speak to the animals. Will that help me in this process?
It can. Yes, it will give you advantage.
All right, I'm going to cast Speak to the Animals.
Speak Spanish?
Yep. He's still cursed, is it?
Spanimals.
Okay. Go ahead.
I took the ring off. All right, so... That was... Hold on, I gotta do it again.
Yep.
Okay, so 18.
With that, you approach the vulture, and it kind of rears back to attack you, and it says, "Stay back!"
I say, "I come in peace."
Only my rider may ride me. I'm waiting on him to return.
Your rider has left the premises. He won't be returning.
Bye-bye.
Do a deception at advantage, because he kind of left, but not really.
I'm so bad at charisma.
He's still here, but he's really dead.
His eyes kind of narrow.
Yeah.
No, he can't leave here without me.
He did not survive the encounter inside.
You killed him?
I killed nobody.
A persuasion. You don't have to do a deception because you did not actually kill anybody.
Do I get
or animal handling, whichever you prefer.
Animal handling, please.
Will something happen?
The best one.
23.
Oh, Jesus.
Thanks for asking the stuff step. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He says, Well, they do have risky careers. The others have left. I guess I will join them.
Thanks, Dub.
Thank you for the info. And he starts flying away.
Oh, wait. I want to stop him. Wait. Don't go.
He's off. But there's still one sitting there.
Okay. Can I talk to him?
Yes, you can.
Join us. Come with us.
Roll an animal handling.
Two.
No. Oh. There's no. I can only... Only those who don the cloak may ride me.
What cloak?
Can I hear this conversation happening?
No, you cannot. It sounds like...
I look at Cavell and... ask him if these beasts are faithful to their evil riders.
I choose not to answer him. I continue my conversation. All
right. Rightfully so.
Damn it.
What?
I've got another fireball I can use today. Come on, Cavell.
Come
Don't
on.
Kill us.
Come with us and you can do some good in the world.
No, I am only interested in meat.
What happened?
I moved you. So you're actually down talking to it.
Well, if you come with us, there is plenty of meat to be had. You see that guy, or I don't know if you heard the explosion inside earlier, but things tend to end up dead around us.
Roll a one final persuasion. Normal.
Can I do animal handling?
Actually, advantage, because you offered him food. Animal handling, yes. Animal handling also.
20.
He says,
"Come on,
show me this meat."
The meat just happens to be your owner. <That's all.
laughs> I don't think he'll care. I guess I'll bring him inside and show him the corpses before.
All right, you're bringing him in and showing him all the dead riders.
I'm gonna try.
No. He just shows them the meat.
I'm showing them the meat.
What is the meat? Describe this meat to me first.
Disassembled.
This meat is like
butchered humans.
Blown up body parts. They're unrecognizable.
So,
the clothes were burned.
They aren't butchered. Charred. You guys have not said you're butchering them or anything.
No, but they're gonna
like delay him for like 8 hours while your buddy's like.
I mean, what does a fireball do to a humanoid body?
The explosion that blew them apart, it charred the remains, and then the cloaks burn, so you can't see the cloaks or anything like that.
But he can see like the like skeleton and like burned flesh, and they look like people still. It's not like they just like turned into steaks.
He's a vulture, like
charred corpses. Well, yeah, recognize
them. I mean, we keep charred corpses around here. I mean,
yeah, absolutely. I'm going to
bring it in.
All right. We need to do it.
So you bring the vulture in, and he
just
sees
one vulture.
He sees the corpses.
I make a sign to Harry like a get ready sign to Harry.
Turns his head around and looks at the corpses, and his eyes kind of widen, and he says, "All of this meat." For me?
No, it's for him. For him and his buddies.
It's for you and any of your friends that you want to join us.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. No, this is for me, for Flintbeak. No friends.
Okay, it's for Flintbeak.
And he kind of starts going down and chomping on the corpses.
If he joins, this loyalty. I need him to be loyal to me as he was to his previous.
He looks at you. Give me one more animal handling at advantage.
Okay. Shit.
He says, Flintbeak. He eat meal. Hang around. See if Harry Man is a good friend to Flintbeak.
Harry Man.
Did someone say Harry Man?
you're the wrong kind of Harry Man.
So he just kind of eats and makes his way around there.
Okay, cool.
He is neutral, but will stay with you for right now. Cool. So you guys, we can I guess we didn't even have the combat music because it was so quick.
Yeah, you're welcome for that.
All right, cool. So you guys wipe them out. You are more than welcome to rest for the night. The vulture is just going to bed down outside on the cloud.
Cloud rests.
Mm-hmm.
So are we on cloud 9? Someone said,
so the next day, Covell,
level 3 spell slots recovered. Got fireballs again, boys.
Covell, go ahead and roll me a d10.
I don't have the ring on anymore.
Doesn't matter.
You're cursed, buddy. Shit.
It's the curse. Yeah, it lives in your DNA, your Metachorian.
Right, 6.
Hey, Grafier, how about removing the curse from you, old buddy?
Your cackle fever that you have worsens.
Great. I mean, great.
And, you actually start laughing so hard that you take 7 points of psychic damage.
Oh Lord!
And you just fall onto the ground, or kind of incapacitated with mad laughter for like a solid minute, just like ha ha ha, and it's so hard.
I wonder if
he's getting weird,
it's wrecking your brain.
He's getting fucking weird.
But after FMS subsides, I will give you another try to convince the giant vulture to follow you.
First, can I try to get Grave here to cure me?
You can try, buddy. You don't have to ask a DM for that.
Yeah.
I don't want to lose my chance with the vulture. Grafier, I need your help.
What do you need, buddy?
Make this go away, please.
What do you need to have gone away?
The curse.
What curse?
God damn it, Grafier.
Sorry, I'm busy right now.
In Grafier's mind, you're just sick. You're just sick.
Can I cast a suggestion, great. Remove the curse from Covell.
Yeah, you can fucking try, bro.
All right, I'm suggesting to Grayfear to cast curse on Covell.
I think the suggestion
when he fails, then he gets the curse too.
So go ahead and give me a wisdom saving throw, Grayfear.
Yep.
Oh heavens, this is a goof and a screw.
Great.
Oh Jesus!
Not only do you make it, you are aware that he tried to cast a spell on you.
Yeah.
go fuck yourself, buddy.
Luckily, you have 5 years of history together. He doesn't just need to trade up.
It's fine.
Clearly, well, this is probably not the first time Harry's tried it on you.
It's really not. I remember the other one. It was that one time at the bar in Bahrain, and it was just really, it was hard.
All right, well, I suggested a threesome, and he said no.
As I turn to the vulture, I'm going to remind Greyfear to a fight that maybe he'll find himself without without support.
Okay. I'll find myself without a stinky bear.
He's not stinky anymore. He's just laughing.
Yeah, I don't think.
No, he's got his new
persuade Greyfear to remove the curse, because like I know it's a fucking curse.
You gotta tell him. And there's no persuasion check because he's a real great person.
Covell put a ring on a couple days
ago. That's done.
He has gotten smellier than he usually was.
He was blind
for one day, and then he woke up with mad laughter, and it's only So what do you think has happened, Covell?
What do I think has happened to him?
Yeah, in the last 4 days, 5 days.
I think that somebody who he thought was a friend gave him an item that was cursed because he wanted to fuck him.
Okay.
That sounds about right.
Mm-hmm.
He wanted to fuck him.
So, since Covell was an item that cursed, we could assume he's now cursed, which is something that you delve in getting rid of, correct?
It's true. I know how to get rid of this, but it's kind of comical to watch it happen day by day. There's like a new problem.
At the same time.
You're laughing at it. He smelled really bad one day. I mean, come on. It's funny.
It is. I get it. It is fair. It's not lost. But at the same time, he's important to things like this gigantic raven that's out of here eating all this meat right now. Wouldn't he be to have on our team?
Well, I mean, you destroyed all the riders. I mean, you were the guy who, like...
All right, this is pointless. I'm going to go talk to the vulture.
I'm going to go talk to the vulture.
This is a waste of time.
Go ahead and handle animal. Handle the animal.
Hold on. First, I'm going to cast Speaks with Animals.
Yep. Animal.
Alright.
So I wanna like have an episode where you two just talk the whole time about a curse.
Oh, you said it because I can talk because that's the point of talking to the animals.
Fucking love it.
Oh yeah, you're right. You know what? We get it. Even after your crazy display. He says, well,
hey, Kat,
if
how many
I get feasts like this all the time
boat.
Then I will why not? You fed me better than them.
Well, there will be
consider
no
me
a feast.
Your friend. He bows down. Excellent. And you now have a giant vulture named Flintbeak who is following you.
Yes.
Yeah, nice.
Is he cute?
No, he's a vulture.
Oh, he's a giant vulture.
Like, it could be cute, like razor face.
Is he like the vulture from like the Jungle Book, like Disney movie, like Wanna Be Friends?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Like the Beatles kind of look.
I assure Flintbeak that we will have many adventures and many meals together.
He's going to die next episode.
All right.
Probably. Is Flintbeak Ringo?
Pringles?
So you guys Ringo? Talk to Flint. Is there anything you want to do today? We can just fast forward as you get closer to town.
I'd like to be cured of a curse.
I want to spend more days watching what kind of curses Covell gets because it's so awesome.
Go ahead and if you guys aren't doing anything, you can rest.
Oh heavens! I'm setting up the tent.
Covell, if nothing happens, 3 days pass. So I need you to roll a 1d10 three times.
Okay.
I'll not do anything. I'll whistle to my chair. Write down some
you're
poems.
Really smelly for a couple days. Like, real smelly. Stinking everyone out. And actually, one night, you're just filled with nightmares. So bad that you cannot actually take a long rest. And you wake up fantastic. Fatigued. But you manage to rest again.
Those nights when I'm really smelly, I make sure I sleep.
Meanwhile, I need to make constitution saving throws for every day, because you're still afflicted with cackle fever. It never goes away.
Oh, fantastic.
So I need a DC, I need a con save. All right, yeah, you cough, and kind of that psychic damage just attacks you again. all three times, you're just like, you're being racked with the psychic damage. Luckily, you long rest, so you get your health back.
Except for one time.
But meanwhile, oh, yeah, that's right. But the third time you do. So,
meanwhile, I start to feel some pity because it's just sad. And so
Thank you.
He has been holding out on this whole thing. Does he have to save the DC 17, or does he have to?
No, that's pass fine. It? He's willing.
I didn't even want your money. I just wanted to watch you suffer for a while.
All right,
that sounds like in character a little bit.
That sounds like a to me.
When you remove the ring, all the effects go away with it as well, including the bonus.
Which that's fine. No longer cursed. Freaking bonus anymore.
Greyfear, Spate gave you a magic item, you think that you can probably get the ring and with some kind of focusing you can get rid of the curse, and you can
need a little bit of focus.
Get the plus one to saving throws.
I know,
ring plus one saving throws, ring of protection. Sweet. Is what it's called. Plus one to saving
Ooh.
Throws. All right, cool.
That's a good item.
So you guys kind of make amends. You heal Covell. Covell bonds with Flintbeak, his little pal.
Skittles gave Harry a magic item.
Harry? We'll take care of it, Harry.
Ooh, thank you so much, Skittles. You're the best. I will chart for you first thing on Wednesday. No more.
You got a chart right now.
If you're there watching Divinity on Wednesday, I'll chart.
All right, cool.
You guys, praise.
The giant, after a few days, kind of comes to you, Harry, and he says,
You'll get that like anime, Chugs.
You're really, you tend to get in trouble a lot, I think.
Resolve trouble, I think is what the word is.
I was going to give you this, and he holds out a small pendant that you could wear. He says, but if you don't think you're getting too much trouble, I'll just take it back upstairs. That's no problem.
I do get in a lot of trouble.
So he bequeaths you this pendant, and it's a Paraptive wound closure. So basically, whenever you wear it, you automatically stabilize when you're dying at the start of your turn. Whenever you roll a hit die to regain hit points, you double the number of hit points you restore.
Oh, shit!
Yep.
Whoa!
We'll take care of it after the fact.
Yeah.
All right, so you guys...
See, but I ended up with a cursed item due to my friend's fate.
As you guys go forward into the north, and it's getting really cold, all of a sudden, a loud crash as something huge kind of crashes into the side of the tower.
A
thud, and you can hear it just kind of go as it lands down on the solid cloud below. And, you see this huge kind of copper-colored shape pop around.
Oh,
you
no.
There he is.
Dragon's head peek in from the side. He's like, hey, guys. it's Felgalos again.
Yeah. Like,
what about Felgalor?
That's
a dragon boy. He's a good boy.
I spotted another Zhentarim caravan. Wanna go blow it up with me?
Hell yeah,
yes. All right, hop on. Let's go get him. And we'll leave right there with you guys.
When we go, can I ride Flintbeak down?
Yes, you can. You absolutely can.
That's cool. Yep.
That's sick. Right. That's cool. Great.
Well, I think that's a good spot to leave it for tonight. We'll leave off with Felgalos next time. Sorry, this tonight was kind of all over the place. I was scattered from that.
Always all over the place.
That's fair.
That is.
But, we get some good backstories. We get some drama.
It's all build up. It'll get it. But Spate, thank you so much for emptying your bank account to ruin the show.
Yes, Spate, thanks for getting me drunk. I really appreciate it.
Yeah. So I've got a piece super bad, so it's gonna be short. But tomorrow,
me too.
I think I'm gonna do some more Prison Architect.
Ooh,
with the women.
That's always a fun one.
And then Wednesday, we got Divinity Original Sin. I think this might be the last one until the full release, but we'll find out.
That's what you said last time.
I know, right? Guys, thanks for hanging out. It was a blast.
We'll
bye, friends.
Time. Maybe next time, old Bilbert will be able to give the doorbell. All right, sounds good. All right, guys, have a good night.
See you again.
Bye.
Cheers.
Now, hey, yo, you rascals, with your bellies full of pie. And listen to this tale of old where the heroes won't be high. Hey! He's a master of concealment and an adept at disguise. With heroes is when he's sick, his master husband puts the lie. He's slain many a villain, be a dragon, football wizard. He's looted chests of all the best of treasures he could find. He's the undefeated champion of adventure, war, and passion. And he sings this song as he goes along with a fiddle and a pipe. The grass is green, the air is clean, a sweet lass by my side. The angel pod is looking so as we are up behind. The world is full of monsters, found the danger at the time. So let your host propose it, so some drunken friends of mine. A hero journey far and wide, but it riches gold and magic. For he never found his true love's son, and it made him sad in time.
Then was Emily was walking, he was shot as he was singing.
And I played him fair from over there with a bow, and she was mine. She apologized profusely, said she thought he was a quarrel. And she carried him to the nearest inn, for she nursed him back to life. Well, it fell in love directly, and she married him that night. So the halfway down the company up the song about that time. The grass is green, the air is clean, the sweet lass by my side. There ain't nobody looking so as sweet.